Hello and welcome. You're watching this NDTV special presentation. I'm Sanket Upadhyay. With me, my colleague Anjali Istwal, and also our very own Dr. Pranoy Roy, right here in the studio. It's a significant little broadcast that we are having right here. We're going to talk about it and explain to you what this is all about. But maybe my colleague Anjali can explain.
जो प्रस्तुति है ये एक विशेष प्रस्तुति है उन मासूमों के लिए जो इस क्राइसिस में जैसे अदृश्य से हो गए यानी गायब से हो गए हैं, जहां गरीब मजदूरों कामगारों की मुसीबतों पर सबकी नजर गई, वहां सड़क पर पलने वाले बच्चों को सब भूल से गए। इस लॉकडाउन और इस बीमारी ने उनकी मुसीबतों को और बढ़ा दिया है।
सो ओवर द नेक्स्ट फ्यू मिनट्स और अ कपल ऑफ आवर्स वी इंटेंड टू स्प्रेड अवेयरनेस अबाउट अ प्रॉब्लम दैट इज ऑफन रिलेगेटेड टू द साइडलाइंस एज अ स्मॉल वन व्हेन डीलिंग विद अ क्राइसिस एज बिग एज कोरोना वायरस. It is time to get that issue back into the spotlight, save our children, they need our help, and make a donation today to make that difference, Dr. Roy.
Yeah, Sanket and Anjali, I think the issue is that there's a bit of good news for children in the sense that coronavirus has a less effect on them, a smaller percentage of children. As the age group goes up, coronavirus hits you much harder. But that's not what they're suffering from. That's why they're tending to be forgotten and becoming invisible. They're suffering because employers that used to hire them are just disappearing and leaving them abandoned. They're out in the streets. Nobody's bothered about them. It is a terrible crisis. It may not be a virus directly in their body, but it is an impact of this pandemic. That's what people are finding difficult to breakthrough. That's what's making them invisible. And the whole idea is now to make them from invisible to visible. They are our children after all.
That's right. And there'll be a little call to action from my side. Be a good citizen and donate for these children whose suffering is invisible, but that doesn't mean that they are not suffering. Exactly. As Pranoy Roy said, that you have to make the invisible visible. That's the intention behind a campaign like this.
और बहुत से तरीके हैं, आप चाहें तो आर्ट का इस्तेमाल भी कर सकते हैं डोनेट करने के लिए. मोजाटो के जरिए आप पेंटिंग खरीद सकते हैं और उसका जो भी पैसा होगा वो इन्हीं बच्चों के लिए, उनको खाना देने के लिए, उनको सुरक्षित रखने के लिए उस पैसे का इस्तेमाल किया जा सकता है. आप लॉग ऑन कर सकते हैं mojato.com/save the children पर. और
the streets are no place for a child, and yet there are more than 20 lakh children on the streets of India. The nationwide lockdown has made them even more vulnerable, even more invisible. Your donations can help feed them and keep them safe. Log on to ndtv.com/theinvisibles for details on how to donate. You can also donate through UPI with the ID SaveTheChildren@SC or on Google Pay by scanning the Save the Children QR code on your screens right now. This is your chance to protect a future generation.
All right, joining us right now is Bidisha Pillai. She's the CEO of Save the Children. Thank you so much, Bidisha, for joining us. First of all, the reason why this campaign was conceptualized, why do you think that it is very, very important to highlight the suffering of these children, more so because of coronavirus?
Well, thank you so much to NDTV for really partnering with us to shine a spotlight on the invisibles. You know, Save the Children has tremendous experience in being the first responders for children in any crisis. So we are the first to arrive and we're the last to leave. And we've done it during the tsunami, during floods in Kerala and Kashmir, during cyclones like Fani, the Nepal earthquake. I mean, every single one of these situations, we've seen that essentially the needs of the children kind of always take a backseat. Right? And if you're looking at catering to adults in the situation of a crisis, the needs of children are very different and cannot be clubbed with the adults. Now, we are today faced by what is probably the greatest challenge of our lifetimes, right, in terms of a crisis. And just as in the other situation, in this situation as well, children have a multiple sort of complications that are complications that they are facing. Firstly, there is very little known about this crisis and how to deal with it. And that awareness and knowledge needs to be translated to the communities and the children. There is definitely the impact of health that we're all hearing about. There is hunger that they're all facing. You know that, you know, we are talking about migrant workers of the poorest families. It's their children who are facing hunger first and foremost. But in addition to that, they're also facing a loss of education. With schools being closed, their access to learning opportunities have been cut off. But for many of these poorest children, it's actually also the place where they would go and get their only proper meal of the day, the midday meal, which is provided in school. And this is just the immediate effect. As the economic crisis probably deepens and families are pushed into poverty, we are likely to see the impact of that on children in terms of increased child labor, more early marriage, trafficking, and many such issues, right? So if you think about the problem, it's got many, many effects that it can actually have on children than we are currently discussing and hearing about.
Right, right. Bidisha, I must say that, you know, we've worked with Save the Children and you and your team for quite some time now. I'm just bowled over by the work that you do and the dedication and passion that is involved. And it's such an important area you're working in. And I've watched how you're always there, as you say, first to arrive. But this is really one of the worst crises you must have faced in all your years. Especially in a lockdown. I mean, you know there are children suffering. How do you even get there? How do you get food to them? How do you make sure that they are taken to a safe place?
Yes, absolutely, Dr. Roy. And so good again to be talking about issues regarding children. You know, you're absolutely right. I think at this point of time, what we've done is to say that our response has to be tailor-made to the problems that we see children facing, right? So what we did is we focused on getting the knowledge and the awareness out to the children. They needed to understand what the pandemic is, how they can, sort of protect themselves from it, and how do they cope with the situation. The second thing that we've been providing, of course, is hygiene and sanitation kits. So things like masks, soap, hand sanitizers, sanitary towels for the slightly older children, dignity kits for pregnant or new mothers, things that they would need as absolutely essential at this point of time. And then the third immediate need is really to tackle the issue of hunger and security, for which we've been providing rations to the children and their families. So things like rice, dal, onions, potatoes, things that they would that they would sustain them, you know, for a longer period of time than the immediate rations that they have for 1 or 2 days.
Yes, Bidisha, thank you so much, Bidisha, for all this information that you've given us. बहुत ज़रूरी हो जाता है कि हमारे वो बच्चे जो इस वक्त सड़कों पर हैं उनके बारे में हम सोचें. बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आपका, और साथ ही में हम हिंदुस्तान का भी शुक्रिया करना चाहेंगे इस मदद में. वी वॉन्ट टू थैंक इंडिया फॉर सपोर्टिंग दिस कॉज. वी हैव अनन्या बिरला ऑफ द अनन्या बिरला फाउंडेशन ऑल्सो कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग टू द कॉज ऑफ फीडिंग एंड प्रोटेक्टिंग स्ट्रीट चिल्ड्रन. अनन्या बिरला, आपका भी और आपकी फाउंडेशन का भी इस सपोर्ट के लिए शुक्रिया. और इस वक्त हमारे साथ जुड़ रही हैं एनसीपीआरसी की चेयरपर्सन प्रियंका कानुंगो. प्रियंक हमारे साथ जुड़ रहे हैं. प्रियंक कानुंगो, हमारे साथ जुड़ने के लिए बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आपका. सबसे अहम चीज़ जो इस वक्त हम जानना चाहेंगे वो ये कि सरकारें अपनी तरफ से कोशिश हमेशा करती हैं कि लोगों को पूरी मदद दी जाए, इसमें ये बच्चे भी शामिल हैं. किस तरीके से सरकार की कोशिशें आगे ले जाती हैं ये एनजीओज भी, और साथ में हम भी सिटीजन्स जो हैं वो कैसे मदद कर सकते हैं?
जी,
जब हम सड़क पे रहने वाले बच्चों करते हैं तो हमको ये समझना होगा कि ये प्रॉब्लम जितनी सोशल है उतनी ही लीगल भी है और इसका समाधान लीगली किया जाना इस वक्त देश में बहुत जरूरी है। COVID-19 के दौर में जब हम बात कर रहे हैं तो ये सरकारों ने सुनिश्चित किया है और मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ होम अफेयर्स ने बहुत ही स्पष्ट लाइन दी है कि जो जहां है उसको शेल्टर दिया जाना बहुत जरूरी है। NCPCR ने भी इसके मद्देनजर सभी राज्य सरकारों को ये निवेदन किया था कि जुवेनाइल जस्टिस एक्ट के सेक्शन 51 में देयर इज अ प्रोविजन कि वो किसी भी जगह को फॉर टाइम बीइंग एक सेफ एक प्लेस किसी जगह जहां बच्चों को रखा जा सके एक सेफ प्लेस उसको डिक्लेयर कर सकते हैं। तो हम लोगों ने जब ये रिकमेंड किया हुआ है तो हॉस्टल्स हैं या स्कूल्स हैं ऐसी कई जगहों को आप फिट फैसिलिटी डिक्लेयर कर सकते हैं जहां बच्चों को रखा जा सके। हमने पुरजोर इस चीज की कोशिश की है एनजीओ के थ्रू की कि बच्चों को किसी भी तरीके से शेल्टर्स में लेके आने की कोशिश की जाए और हमने सभी स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स को भी रिक्वेस्ट की।
जी उम्मीद करते हैं प्रियंक की आपकी बात को सभी राज्य सरकारें इसके उस पर गौर करेंगी और इस पर अमल भी करेंगी। हमसे बात करने के लिए बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आपका। तो सबसे अहम शायद वो हो जाते हैं जो खुद बच्चे हैं जो मुसीबतों को समझते हैं जो उनके जैसे बच्चे हैं उनकी मुसीबतों को समझते हैं और ऐसी ही एक चाइल्ड चैंपियन सेव द चिल्ड्रन की हमारे साथ जुड़ गई हैं निशा हमारे साथ हैं। निशा आपका बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया। जिस उम्र में बच्चे खेलने कूदने में व्यस्त होते हैं आप कुछ ऐसा कर रही हैं जिससे हम लोगों को प्रेरणा लेनी चाहिए। क्या क्या करती हैं आप?
मैंने अब तक मैम बहुत कुछ कर लिया है और मुझे बहुत खुशी होती है जब मैं ये सब करती हूँ और अच्छा लगता है। सो जैसे कि हम सब जानते हैं अभी कोरोना चल रहा है तो हमारे देश में बहुत बुरे हालात हैं बट फिर भी हम कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि हम उन सब से लड़ सकें। तो जब कोरोना स्टार्ट हुआ और जब हमारे PM सर ने लॉकडाउन लगाया तो काफ़ी हालात ठीक थे लेकिन वो फिर जैसे लॉकडाउन बढ़ा तो फिर हालात बिगड़ गए। तो फिर जब मैंने आसपास देखा अपने तो जो फैमिली थी वो मतलब बहुत पैनिक हो रही थी क्योंकि किसी के पास राशन वगैरह नहीं था क्योंकि कोई रोज़मर्रा की चीज़ों में कोई ड्राइवर है कोई मजदूर है तो सब अपना डेली बेसिस पे काम करते थे तो उनको दिक्कतें आ रही थी। तो मैंने सोचा कि जो हमारा NGO है सेव द चिल्ड्रन मैं उधर एक बार कॉल कर ये पता करूँ कि क्या वो मतलब मदद कर सकते हैं। वैसे तो वो हमारी मदद हमेशा करते हैं बट फिर भी थोड़ा कंफ्यूजन था तो मैंने कॉल किया एंड मैंने फिर पता किया तो उन्होंने कहा बिल्कुल हम मदद करेंगे। और फिर सेव द चिल्ड्रन की मदद से मैंने यहाँ पे जो रह रही हैं फैमिलियाँ 10-12 फैमिलियाँ उनको राशन दिलाया एंड मैं बहुत खुश हूँ कि मैंने उन्हें राशन दिला पाई। और हम मतलब कि पहले तो हम भी बुरे हालातों से गुजरी हूँ मैं भी लेकिन अब ठीक हूँ। मतलब बिल्डिंग में हम लोग रह रहे हैं जो हमारे मालिक हैं उन्होंने हमें दिया है कमरा लेकिन पहले हम भी कई ऐसी जगह रहे हैं।
निशा बहुत बहुत बढ़िया काम आपने किया और उम्मीद करते हैं ये आगे भी करते रहेंगे।
जिस तरीके से वो बयान कर रही थी। हाँ निशा कुछ कह रही है। निशा जल्दी से हाँ बताएं क्या।
सो मैम मैं ये कहना चाहूंगी सर जैसा कि अभी तो हम बिल्डिंग में और सो मैं थोड़ी मतलब एजुकेटेड भी हूँ तो मुझे पता है कि मैं NGO से भी जुड़ी हूँ तो मैं मदद मांग पाई लेकिन उन बच्चों का क्या जो सड़क पे रह रहे हैं जिन्हें पता नहीं कि हम पर भी कौन से NGO काम कर रहे हैं या नहीं तो मैं चाहूंगी कि हमारी मदद तो हुई मेरे जैसे और भी बच्चों की मदद हो जैसे जो सड़कों पे रहते और नहीं मदद ले पाते।
ये निशा का जो सवाल है वो इट पर्टेन्स टू अवेयरनेस डॉक्टर रॉय। इट्स वेरी सिंपली शी वाज अवेयर इनफ टू नो अबाउट एन NGO बट व्हाट अबाउट दोज हेल्पलेस चिल्ड्रन हु डू नॉट इवन नो दैट देयर इज समवन आउट देयर टू हेल्प देम। आई थिंक दैट्स व्हाई ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस लाइक सेव द चिल्ड्रन बिकम वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। विकी रॉय इज ऑल्सो विद अस। ही इज एन एस फोटोग्राफर ही नाउ जॉइंस अस। विकी रॉय की कहानी भी बहुत ही रोचक है। उन्होंने स्ट्रीट्स को सर्वाइव किया है एज अ यंग चाइल्ड और अब एक बड़े कामयाब और काबिल फोटोग्राफर हैं और उन्होंने जो उनका प्रोजेक्ट है उसका नाम है द इनविजिबल्स। विकी रॉय इस कार्यक्रम में आपका स्वागत है। मैं सबसे पहले आपसे ये जानना चाहता हूं, द इनविजिबल्स प्रोजेक्ट क्या है?
द इनविजिबल प्रोजेक्ट है कि बेसिकली 2 साल पहले हमने ये प्रोजेक्ट सेव द चिल्ड्रन ने मुझे ऑफर किया ये करने के लिए, और आई एम वेरी एक्साइटेड जब मुझे ये प्रोजेक्ट मिला कि यू नो कि मैं खुद ऐसे सिचुएशन से आता हूँ, और मुझे पता है कि जब शेल्टर होम में रहता था और मैं बड़ा हो रहा था एंड उसके बाद जब हमें बैंक अकाउंट खुलवाना था या अपना आईडी कार्ड बनाना था तो हमें अधिकार देते थे
कि अगर अपने जिस एनजीओ में हम रहे वहां का अगर हम वो लेके जाते थे बिजली बिल तो वो तो कहते थे कि ये तो तुम्हारे फादर का नाम नहीं है, मम्मी का नाम नहीं है, तो बनाते नहीं थे। तो हम ना हमारा अगर कुछ हमें कुछ चीज आता भी है ना तो टेक्निकली हम अपने आप को बहुत कमजोर पाते थे। तो कोई आईडी प्रूफ नहीं होने की वजह से ना हम हमेशा अपने आप को छोटा और हमेशा वो कमजोर पाते थे। तो जब ये प्रोजेक्ट मिला और जब हम ये प्रोजेक्ट कर रहे थे तो वो सेम चीज में इन बच्चों के अंदर देख पा रहा था, बिकॉज इनको भी कहीं ना कहीं ये प्रॉब्लम से गुजरना पड़ा है, और प्लस जब इनके पास में फाइनली वो एक आईडी प्रूफ बन के आया तो इनके चेहरे पे एक अलग मुस्कान थी, जैसा आप ये फोटोज में देख सकते हैं कि, और मैंने उसी तरीके से कोशिश किया कि यू नो ठीक है स्ट्रीट पे रहते हैं हम ठीक है, बट ना क्या है कि ये जब आप मैंने फोटो इस तरीके से शूट किया कि कोई इसे दया की नजरिए से ना देखे कि यू नो ये बहुत ऐसा है वैसा है, क्योंकि जब हम सलाम बालक में रह रहे थे हमें चीजें मिल रही थी, हमारे लिए वो लग्जरी था, हमें शेल्टर होम में जो फैसिलिटी मिलती है हमारे लिए वो लग्जरी था, और मैं हमेशा कहता हूँ कि एक लोअर मिडिल क्लास को जो फैसिलिटी
मिलती है। लेकिन फर्क कितना पड़ा मेरे हिसाब से तो ये 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 एक बहुत ही जबरदस्त और इट्स एन इंस्पायरिंग स्टोरी व्हाट वी आर हियरिंग एट दिस मोमेंट विकी रॉय, एंड सम ऑफ योर पिक्चर्स आई कैन सी ऑन द साइड, आई मस्ट से दैट दीज आर रिमार्केबल पिक्चर्स, नॉट जस्ट द कॉम्पोजिशन, नॉट जस्ट द फ्रेम, बट द थॉट बिहाइंड दीज पिक्चर्स, जो आपने भाव लगाए हैं, जो आप भाव उत्पन्न करने की कोशिश की है वो काबिले तारीफ है। संजय रॉय भी हमारे साथ जुड़ गए हैं, संजय रॉय रन्स दिस सलाम बालक ट्रस्ट, इनफैक्ट विकी इज अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ द सलाम बालक ट्रस्ट। संजय, हाउ डज इट फील टू सी एन आइडिया टेकिंग शेप वेयर वेयर यू कैन सी दैट द इंटेंशन विद विच यू यू वेंट अहेड विद एन आइडिया has taken proper shape?
Thanks so much. Thank you NDTV for doing this and Save the Children, and you know, really proud of people like Vicky. Vicky's photographs today you can see across the world in most of the biggest museums of the world, including at the World Trade Center, which he photographed for a while, as you all know. But really, Salaam Bala Trust is, you know, it's 30 years old. We started it when street children wasn't necessarily either the flavor of the moment. But it's just so important. I mean, these are kids, you're talking about social distancing now. Well, these are kids who always face social distancing as many different aspects of our society. And it's so important even today, where there's even less support on the street, for you guys to be able to focus on the needs of the children who have nothing. They don't come under any scheme. They have no access to any kind of facilities. And really, as Vicky said, and Save the Children said, they're the voiceless and nameless, but they are citizens of India, and they have rights to a livelihood, a safe place to stay, food, education, and most importantly, the right to dream, the right to dream of a better future, which unfortunately, again and again, is denied of them.
Sanjoy, Pranoy here, lovely to have you with us. Of course, I've been following your work for years and it's just amazing. In your day-to-day functioning, you know, we call these children invisible. Of course, one of the problems is they don't have a vote. If they had a vote, they'd be really visible. But apart from that, do you find in interacting with them, the parents can sometimes be a little conservative, especially with their daughters, and not let them develop and don't look after them as well as they could? Are there impediment and how do you handle that?
So Pranoy, most of the kids who we look after are kids who run away from home, so they're not with their parents.
Right.
So they've come, they're in the big cities, and you know, they come, they leave their home. So you can imagine what a huge step it is for a child who's 7 or 9 or 12 to actually leave home, girl or boy. The girls obviously have far more difficult situations because there's the kind of social pressure that you find. Unfortunately, the new laws that we have to cope with, you know, the kids are willingly sent home. And we keep trying to tell the courts that not every home is welcoming. And And that's the nature of any family anywhere in the world, where mental health, great poverty, alcoholism, drugs, etc. These are some of the causes why the kids leave home to begin with. So what we try and do is empower them, try and see if they go home, can we find a place in the local school where we sort of create a golden goose situation.
And how is it working in the lockdown?
In the lockdown, it's obviously very difficult. Of course, for our kids in the home, you know, they're just amazing and they've taken to the lockdown incredibly. We thought it would be really problematic, but it's really our staff. We're really at the forefront of this, like all of these others who, you know, the doctors and nurses, they're working 7 days a week because we don't want them to go in and out of the shelter homes. So they're pretty much part of that regime that they have to stay there 7 days a week. So the kids are fine who are at home. Kids on the street, and there's a growing number with street families, kids on the street. For them, of course, it's very difficult. What is the Lakshman Rekha for them? Is it the 1 square foot that they have where they sleep or they stay in? I mean, you know, we don't get it when you say in India, don't leave your home. The street is their home. So where is it that you want them to go?
Tragic.
It's absolutely tragic. Or yahi ek क्या बोलें, एक बहुत अजीब सी एक विडंबना है जो कि देखने मिल रही है. सरकार कहती है घर में रहो, लेकिन उन लोगों का क्या जिनके पास घर ही नहीं है. दे डोंट हैव द प्रीरिक्विजिट टू स्टे एट होम, अ होम.
बिल्कुल, छत नहीं है सर छुपाने के लिए, बहुत बड़ी दिक्कत है. लेकिन कुछ ऐसे लोग हैं जो कि इन बच्चों के साथ काम करते आए हैं, उनमें से एक हैं दिया मिर्जा. शी इज एन एक्टर, शी इज अ प्रोड्यूसर, शी इज आर्टिस्ट एम्बेसडर फॉर सेव द चिल्ड्रन, यूएनईपी गुडविल एम्बेसडर एंड यूएन सेक्रेटरी जनरल्स एडवोकेट फॉर
एंड अ हार्ट ऑफ गोल्ड. शी इज डन सो मेनी टेलीथॉन्स विद अस.
यस
यस,
रियली इन्वॉल्वड एंड मूव्ड बाय योर पैशन टू हेल्प सोसाइटी.
एंड शी हेट्स प्लास्टिक. This must be mentioned.
दिया, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आपका हमारे साथ जुड़ने के लिए. जैसे संजय बता रहे थे, अभी की स्थिति में इन बच्चों तक मदद पहुंचाना या इनको लोगों के सामने लाना बहुत मुश्किल हो जाता है. आपका एक्सपीरियंस क्या रहा है? आमतौर पर भी कितनी दिक्कतें होती हैं, तो अब जबकि लॉकडाउन है, कोविड महामारी है, कितनी ज्यादा दिक्कतें हो रही होंगी?
फॉर मेकिंग द इनविजिबल विजिबल. आप लोग ये प्रोग्राम कर रहे हैं, इसलिए बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. आई एम वर्किंग विद सेव द चिल्ड्रन एज एन आर्टिस्ट एम्बेसडर सिंस 2016. एंड 2016 तक हमने ये कैंपेन लॉन्च किया था, द इनविजिबल्स कैंपेन, जहाँ पे हमारी उम्मीद यही थी कि जो हमारे देश के 20 लाख बच्चे जो स्ट्रीट सिचुएशन में रहते हैं या स्ट्रीट में रहते हैं, उन तक हम आइडेंटिटी पहुंचाए. And kyunki we realized that whatever it was, whatever they needed access to, whether it was health, school, or education, or practically anything, needed for them to have identity, some form of identity. So, Aadhaar card banwaya humne. और इस दौरान मेरी बहुत अच्छे, बहुत खूबसूरत बच्चों के साथ मुलाकात हुई है. Over the last 2 years, I had the good fortune of interacting with some of the brightest, most curious, most wonderful, vibrant children in our country. And मैं सिर्फ यही कहना चाहूंगी कि मेरी सीख हमेशा, जब भी मैं उनके साथ इंटरेक्ट करती हूँ और लौट के वापस आती हूँ, यही है कि जिस तरह की दिक्कतों के बावजूद वो, जिस तरह की दिक्कतों के साथ वो रहते हैं, उसके बावजूद जिस तरह का रेजिलियंस, जिस तरह की जोश, जिस तरह का उम्मीद उनमें नजर आती है, वो हम जैसे प्रिविलेज लोग जिनके घर होते हैं और सब कुछ होता है, उनमें नहीं नजर आती. एंड आई थिंक दैट यू नो, स्पेशली व्हेन यू इंटरैक्ट विद चिल्ड्रन लाइक सलमान, मनीषा स्पेशली आई वुड लाइक टू मेंशन हियर, हु लिव्स अंडर एल्फिंस्टन फ्लाईओवर इन मुंबई. एंड व्हेनेवर आई कैंपेन, वेदर इट इज टू बीट एयर पोल्यूशन और you know, when for plastic pollution or just the environmental degradation and the fact that children, the ones who actually on the front line, and we've been hearing this word a lot, but I feel like our children are on the front line of exposure to every extreme situation that we experience as a society. And so it actually strengthens my strengthens me when I meet children like Manisha, jo, despite living under a flyover, all the impediments that she has to face on a daily basis,
in fact,
is educating herself, is supporting other children, is
fighting
for life. And when you hear her speak, you will be spellbound. That's what she's joining us tonight.
Okay, we'll come back to you in just a second. We've got Aparna Sen with us right now. It's really great to have you with us, Aparna Sen. I got a wonderful and eye-opening email today from Sainath. And he was talking about the telethons we're doing and all that. And as you know, for children, and this we're focusing on children, they suffer from various other illnesses because of hygiene, because of the conditions they're living in. And now that they're abandoned by their parents and employers all over the country, he basically raised one major issue, and that is there's going to be a huge shortage of water. And we keep saying, wash your hands for 20 seconds. They won't even have good, clean water to drink. So how do you get over some of the basic problems that hit our children more, like a shortage of water?
Yeah, I know. But, this needed to be, and let's not go into what needed to be done, but I think it still needs to be done. I mean, there have to be shelter homes for these children with running water, with proper toilets, so that there can be basic minimum hygiene.
Right. Can I just ask one other question? And that is, you're such a creative person and you can change people's minds and you have a great influence, you have a fan following. The big issue at the moment is stigma attached to people who have COVID-19. How can you produce or influence in some way and counteract the stigma? You know, the neighbors got it, don't go there, beat him up. And, you know, how does one do that? How, any suggestions to you and your creative fraternity to counteract stigma, which is a byproduct of this pandemic?
Try and do that. In my Facebook page, I have a poetry room where I've been reciting poetry, translating Bengali poetry into English, etc., where I can, one of the things that I can say every single time is this. I can say it every single time that I do a program. I will say it, and I'll also ask my colleagues to do what they can.
Right, wonderful.
That's very, very good to hear, Aparna Sen. Thank you so much for joining us on this broadcast. Thank you so much. We need crusaders for a mission like this, because these are the invisible who have to be made visible. Anindit Roy Chaudhary is with the Save the Children mission. He's always the first to respond because, as the motto of Save the Children is, the children can't wait. Give us a sense, Anindit, of the practical challenges that you are facing at this moment, particularly post-lockdown in these COVID-19 times. How are children the most vulnerable? Any practical experience?
Yeah, of course. Thank you very much. A few things are very clear. One, of course, is the fact that, in this lockdown, for us to even move with the food items that Bidisha was talking about, or the hygiene kits or the dignity kits, that in itself is quite difficult. However, we have found great support from the state governments. We are currently responding in 10 states, and we have found great support from the state governments in giving us the adequate permission to be able to actually do this. The other thing that we are doing is, even in terms of making these provisions available, we are following the World Food Program guidelines for distribution. So we know that these are human rights sensitive in the way we are delivering food and not just kind of throwing them in bulks, etc., which is happening in several other places. The last is, we have also, we just heard one of our child champions, and we know that there will be others who will be speaking as well. Child champions and young advocates have done a tremendous job in actually facilitating distribution of articles on the ground, and played a tremendous role in being the leaders on the ground in doing this. So if you also look at the visuals that you have, you will realize that children themselves and young adults themselves who have been part of our programs have taken active steps themselves in being protagonists and leaders in being able to distribute. So So I think that also has been an exceptionally, whilst it is challenging, it's also been terribly, you know, it's a matter of gratefulness or gratitude that we have, where children have come forward and helped us in the process.
Absolutely. और ऐसी ही एक child champion जैसे कि आप कह ही रहे हैं, गायत्री इस वक्त हमारे साथ phone line पर जुड़ गई हैं. उन्होंने भी अपने इलाके के लोगों को खाना पहुंचाने के लिए district magistrate तक गुहार लगाई. गायत्री, हमसे बात करने के लिए शुक्रिया आपका. किस तरीके से आपको कैसे लगा कि हाँ जरूरत है, यहाँ मुझे कुछ करना पड़ेगा, और जब आप आगे बढ़ी करने के लिए डिस्ट्रिक्ट मजिस्ट्रेट से बात करना, आमतौर पर कोई लोग डरते हैं डिस्ट्रिक्ट मजिस्ट्रेट से बात करने के लिए, लेकिन आप इतनी छोटी उम्र में उनके पास मांग के साथ पहुंच गई, क्या हुआ?
जी मैं शादी बच्चों का खेल नहीं परियोजना से जुड़ी हूँ, जो लड़कियों के बेहतरीन के लिए 2016 से रीगा में काम कर रही है, उन्हीं के माध्यम से मैं अपनी बातों को जिलाधिकारी तक पहुंचा पाई हूं।
जी
बहुत बढ़िया। गायत्री मैं एक चीज आपसे पूछना चाहता हूं, जब आप जिला मैजिस्ट्रेट के पास गईं, तो वो उन्होंने बोला क्या जब आपने अपनी बात रखी? वो तो हिल गए होंगे कि ये कौन आ गया।
नहीं सर, जब कोरोना संकट के बाद हमारे परिवार की स्थिति इतनी बिगड़ गई कि मेरे परिवार सहित हमारे मुसल समुदाय के सैकड़ों घरों में खाने पीने की दिक्कत हो गई, तो मैं सोच रही थी कि मैं अपनी बात किससे कहूं, लेकिन इसी बीच एक सरिता दीदी है उन्हीं का कॉल आया। सरिता दीदी हमसे बोली कि गायत्री तुम्हारी क्या स्थिति है, तो हम दीदी को अपनी सारी बात बताई और दीदी ने हमारी बातों को गंभीरतापूर्वक लेते हुए बोले कि एक पत्र लिखो डीएम के पास जिससे तुम्हारी समस्या का हल हो सकता है। तो मैंने लिखी डीएम के आधार पे एक पत्र लिखे, जिन्होंने सरिता दीदी कमल सर के माध्यम से आगे बढ़ाई जिलाधिकारी तक, और मेरी समस्या का हल हुआ और जिलाधिकारी ने तुरंत दो दिन बाद ही खाद सामग्री बंटवाना शुरू कर दिए, और मैं बहुत खुश हूँ कि लोगों ने हमारी इस पहल से बहुत खुश है और मुझे बधाई भी दे रही है।
हम भी आपको बधाई देंगे गायत्री, आपने बहुत अच्छा काम किया, आपने राह दिखाई है दूसरे बच्चों को भी और दूसरे लोगों को, हम जैसे लोगों को भी आपने राह दिखाई है, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आपका। विदिशा, यहाँ मैं आपसे पूछना चाहूंगी कि बच्चों से बच्चे जिस तरीके से कनेक्ट कर सकते हैं, बात कर सकते हैं, वो शायद एक अडल्ट जाके बात करता है तो नहीं हो पाता है, तो जब ये चाइल्ड चैंपियंस आपके साथ काम करते हैं तो क्या इससे आपको कोई सहूलियत होती है?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, I think that the change that these children are able to bring, जो child champions हैं, वो हमारे खुद के program से उठ के आते हैं, वो कई मुश्किलों से गुजरते हैं और जब वो अपनी जिंदगी में एक बदलाव लाते हैं और वो समझते हैं कि इस बदलाव को कैसे लाए, वो फिर उसको like wild fire they are able to spread it within their community and you know outside. So just look at Gayatri. I mean, her one initiative, 950 families In that little village have benefited. Nisha, you will hear from Sumit, who's spreading awareness. So for Save the Children, we believe that participation of children, their voice, and their ability really to champion change within their communities is what will drive sustainable change for India going forward. You know, the crisis we are facing now, it's challenging a generation. So anything that we can do at this point of time is really going to be an effort to protect this generation. And it's fantastic that young children are taking part in that as well.
Absolutely. Or is what हमारे साथ अमोद कांत जुट गए हैं जो कि जनरल सेक्रेटरी हैं प्रयास के, एक एनजीओ है, फॉर्मर डीजीपी भी हैं वो अरुणाचल प्रदेश के, और साथ में नेहा धूपिया भी जुड़ गई हैं हमारे साथ, एक्टर, जाना माना पहचाना हुआ चेहरा। आप दोनों का शुक्रिया हमारे साथ जुड़ने के लिए। मिस्टर कांत, लेट्स बिगिन विद यू। वी हैव बीन टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ चिल्ड्रन कैन बी सॉर्ट ऑफ द ड्राइवर्स ऑफ चेंज दैट वी सीक right now. Do you think we as citizens right now that this children are probably in the worst condition right especially on the streets, we as citizens can help right now?
See, I'm really horrified to think that what must be happening to nearly 20 million children who happen to be the orphans, the homeless, without family care, without protection. You know, I am working for children. I mean, we have got nearly 40 homes in which we look after about 2,000, 3,000 children. And we are trying to feed and we are trying to shelter about 5,000 people. But then they are nothing. It's peanuts. And this campaign is so important, so very important. If we are able to reach out to them. You know, we have got the child helpline, 1098. And this child helpline, it gets about 3 lakh call in a month. I think it could be a very powerful medium also to reach out to those kind of children. And because they are with the families. See, those who are with the families, they are in huge difficulty. Those kind of children who belong to those kind of families where they don't have money to look after themselves, where they can't feed themselves. And think of those children who happen to be outside on the street, who happen to be working children, who happen to be in difficult circumstances. I have heard about children in Rajasthan, Jaipur, for example. There are 50,000 children in Jaipur who happen to be child labor. They are all locked up in situations of total misery. So you understand those kind of children. And I think that this entire campaign should target them first, who happen to be in extremely difficult circumstances. I would like to just point out a very small thing. See, along with Save the Children and others, we are working through Niti Aayog also. Niti Aayog has a list of 92,000 voluntary organizations. I am a member coordinator in the body, where we are trying to address them across the country so that they are able to reach out to those people who need our services.
This is really great to hear, Mr. Kant, because it's interesting that they're not so invisible. At least the government has taken note.
I've just got a fantastic message. I have to. Natasha and Adar Poonawala, he's the CEO of the Serum Institute of India.
Yeah.
He says, we would like to donate 50 lakhs to your charity to save the children. 50 lakhs.
God bless you.
I'd just like to interrupt and interject. This is just so wonderful. And these are the kind of people we need, more and more of them. You know, there's a lot of talk that we can do, but this kind of talk really needs to encourage people to come forward and you know, donate. And that's what all of you at NDTV and, you know, people like Natasha and others.
I wanted to ask you, Neha, can you appeal to everybody to donate, because, you know, the children out there really need it, and Save the Children Fund. Save the Children will actually get the funds to them. If you
yes,
can appeal
absolutely.
To everyone.
Dr. Roy, I would love to do this. And, you know, I'm absolutely uninhibited about this. I want to fold my hands on national television and request everybody, please come forward. And no amount of, a donation is ever small. So do not check yourselves before doing that. Only check yourselves if you're not going to come forward and donate. These kids, you know, we've been harping for so long saying that, you know, social distancing, stay home, stay safe. The question is, where are their homes? They don't have homes. Where will they be safe?
Exactly.
They will be susceptible to so many things apart from, you know, just the disease. There's also crime out there. There's also danger out there. There's so much that needs to be looked after when it comes to these children. Firstly, thank you for doing this. And in advance, I'd like to thank everybody who's going to come forward and donate. And no amount is small.
Wonderful. Thank you. That's
thank
great.
You. Thank you
great.
So much, Neha Dhupia, as well as Mr. Amod Kant. It's a very
thank
passionate
you,
statement and an appeal that has been made by Neha. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Graffi is the chairman and MD India of Piaggio Vehicles Private Limited, has sent us this message. Let's play that out.
I would like to thank Save the Children and DTV to invite me for a pledge to this noble cause. We are definitely in the middle of a universal crisis, and the lives of millions, billions of people will be affected, and for some of them may be lifelong. During this pandemic, the consequences on the kids, on the children that are connected to streets, that are living in slums, the kids of daily wages, will be affected most. Via Piaggio has taken a lot of initiative already in order to support the unprivileged and weakest part of India population during this pandemic. For example, we are providing regularly food rations kits to migrant workers, 1,000 migrant workers, their family and kids, which are living in nearby Baramati area, where our plant is in Maharashtra. Furthermore, we decided to support local government hospital in Pune and Baramati, providing them contribution in order to let them have enough supplies of PPE kits, medical supplies, sanitization kits, and through the creation of isolation ward specially dedicated for the treatment of COVID-19 patients. when we got to know about the initiative of School Save the Children through the project Make the Invisible Visible to support the lives of millions of children in India that are fighting in poverty, we decided to join hands in hands immediately. It is in DNA of both organizations to do all possible efforts to protect kids and children that are struggling in poverty. And think that as an organization, we can take a lot of advantage from the rich experience of Save the Children in this field. And sure, we will have possibility to do more ambitious projects in the future.
नेहा धूपिया हमारे साथ अभी भी हैं. नेहा, मैं एक सवाल आपसे पूछना चाहता था. आप इस एनजीओ से, सेव द चिल्ड्रन से बहुत लंबे समय से जुड़ी हुई हैं, खास तौर से ऐसे वक्त में जब COVID-19 है, जब लॉकडाउन है, ऐसे में बच्चों का जिक्र करना क्यों जरूरी हो जाता है, मैं आपसे जानना चाहता हूँ.
आई थिंक सबसे अहम जो चीज है, हमको बच्चों के का ही जिक्र करना है, क्योंकि सबसे पहले हमें ये चीज का एहसास दिलाना है सब लोगों को कि जब से ये पैंडेमिक की बात शुरू हुई है, वी हैव ओनली बीन टॉकिंग अबाउट द फैक्ट दैट द पीपल हु आर मोस्ट इन डेंजर राइट नाउ आर चिल्ड्रन, एंड द वंस हु आर मोस्ट इन डेंजर राइट नाउ आर ओल्डर पीपल. एंड व्हेन इट कम्स टू सेविंग चिल्ड्रन हु आर ऑन द स्ट्रीट, वी हैव टू लुक एट दैट वेरी लार्ज नंबर दैट्स आउट देयर दैट्स हेल्पलेस, और आगे उनको पता भी नहीं क्या हो रहा है. आधे से ज्यादा लोगों को वहां पे जो बच्चे हैं, अगर हम अपनी बेसिक नेसेसिटीज के लिए भी जाएं, देयर आर टाइम्स व्हेन I worry so much because उनके पास mask नहीं है, उनके पास basic facilities नहीं है. Yes, we are trying our best to do as much as we can, but अगर हम आज के इस initiative के साथ या NDTV और Save the Children के साथ जुड़ें, तो हम और भी कुछ कर सकते हैं सिवाय ये सोचने की, you know, what are the steps forward? At least we know that you guys are taking the right direction, because they are the ones who are most in danger right now. हम खुद, मैं खुद एक माँ हूँ, और मैं खुद जब अपने बच्चे के, जैसे मैंने इस पेंडेमिक के बारे में सुना, एंड दिस वुड गो टू पेरेंट्स अक्रॉस द बोर्ड, दैट द वन थिंग दैट यू थिंक ऑफ इमीडिएटली इज योर चाइल्ड, बट दीज आर चिल्ड्रन आउट देयर, हू इज थिंकिंग अबाउट देम, देयर पेरेंट्स आर, एंड इवन इफ दे आर, व्हाट कैन दे डू अबाउट इट. वी आर द वंस हू कैन कम फॉरवर्ड एंड डू सो मच मोर.
बिल्कुल, सबसे ज्यादा चिंता की बात शायद यही है कि जो लोग, बच्चे सड़कों पर रहते हैं अक्सर, उनके लिए चिंता करने वाला कोई नहीं रहता. हमारे साथ बात करने के लिए बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आपका नेहा. और इस वक्त हमारे साथ विशाल मिश्रा जुड़ गए हैं, जो कि एक इंडियन म्यूजिक कंपोजर हैं, सिंगर भी हैं. विशाल, आपने एक गाना बनाया जो कि खास तौर पर COVID-19 को लेकर ही था, तो पहले तो आपसे जानना चाहेंगे कि क्या सोच रही उसके पीछे, और उसके बाद आपसे रिक्वेस्ट ये भी करेंगे जरूर कि वो गाना एक बार हम सबको जरूर सुनाएं.
जरूर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि हम सारे इस वक्त सोल्जर्स हैं विदाउट द जर्सी ऑन अस, एंड हर इंसान के मन में आज की रेट में, वेदर हूएवर द पर्सन इज फ्रॉम एंड व्हाट द क्रीड एंड कास्ट इज, इट डजंट मैटर, पर मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि सबके अंदर ये जज्बा जरूर है कि हिंदुस्तान के लिए कुछ करना है. वहीं से वो ख्याल आया मुस्कुराएगा इंडिया बनाने का, और एक ऐसा गाना बनाना था जिसमें कुछ भी नेगेटिव ना हो, जिसमें सिर्फ पॉजिटिव चीजें हो, और सारे लाइक माइंडेड लोग एक साथ जुड़ गए, एंड एवरीबडी केम ऑन बोर्ड, एंड एवरीबडी शॉट देयर वीडियोस एट देयर हाउसेस, एंड हमने वो गाना निकाला जस्ट टेलिंग एवरीबडी कि अगर हम आज साथ रहे, इस वक्त अगर हमने एक दूसरे का साथ दिया, इस वक्त अगर हम जो हमें कहा जा रहा है वो हमने किया, तो आगे हमारा फ्यूचर बहुत खूबसूरत है. एंड आई थिंक वी हैव फॉट अ लॉट ऑफ बैटल्स, and this is a battle, and being soldiers at home, हमें बस positivity रखनी है और एकता रखनी है, और I'm so glad कि वो गाना बाहर आया और उसने इतने सारे करोड़ों भारतीयों को जोड़ा और इतनी positivity फैलाई. So I think for an artist, it's something that makes me feel full of gratitude, और I hope कि वो गाना किसी न किसी रूप में इंसानों को positive महसूस करा सके.
जरूर. Please play.
Should I?
Yes, please do, please do.
This is for the whole of the country, पूरे हिंदुस्तान के लिए मेरी तरफ से, कि कल अच्छा है, बस आज साथ रहने की जरूरत. फिर से शहरों में रौनक आएगी, फिर से गाँव में लौटेगी हंसी फिर से साथ सारे यार होंगे ना होगी पाबंदी ना रोक ही कोई ऐसे सड़कों पे सब नाचेंगे पटरी पे पहिए भागेंगे गूंजेंगे खेलों के मैदान बांटेंगे हम खुशियां हम भी हम मिलकर बांटेंगे फिर से होगी सपनों की उड़ान जो साथ दे दे सारा इंडिया फिर मुस्कुराएगा इंडिया फिर जीत जाएगा इंडिया जो साथ दे सारा इंडिया फिर मुस्कुराएगा इंडिया फिर मुस्कुराएगा इंडिया
बहुत खूब
बहुत खूब बहुत खूब विशाल बहुत ही जबरदस्त इंडिया को मुस्कुराना ही है और हम मुस्कुराएंगे आसपास देखिए
बहुत जरूरी है
दिक्कत जरूर है लेकिन उस दिक्कत से निपट लेंगे क्योंकि बहुत अच्छे लोग हैं कोंकणा सेन शर्मा भी अब हमारे साथ जुड़ गई हैं अभिनेता हैं कोंकणा वेलकम ऑन द शो I've been asking this question. We asked this of Neha Dhupia also and many other celebrities. Why is it very important to discuss children or to save those children more so at this time, in the times of COVID-19 and lockdown? They're silent sufferers.
Yes, absolutely. First of all, I want to say that it's so wonderful that NDTV has taken up this initiative because, you know, the problem is that this is not something that is visible to us. You know, I think for a lot of people who are sitting in their homes and not going out or not seeing these children on the streets necessarily, it's something that, you know, they are probably consumed with this unprecedented time in their lives when they also have to deal with a lot of things. So people are not aware. You know, or, you know, they are seeing it as a separate problem. They're not seeing it as, you know, that these are future citizens. They are the most vulnerable. They are the most helpless people. And we have to come together, you know, as a society, as a people to help these children who have no one else to help them. And you know, they're so vulnerable and they have no one else. And we have to really rally together, all of us. And I think you guys have done a wonderful job of doing that. And if, you know, we are sitting in our living rooms and watching NDTV, and, you know, sitting with AC and we have food in our fridge, we are so privileged and we are so much in the minority that, you know, it is very important that we remember. It is our duty that we remember and, you know, find that compassion in your heart to help the people who have no other help, to help the most vulnerable, to help children who perhaps have no homes.
Yeah. Konkana, this is Pranoy here. Thanks very, very much for coming on. And it's great to have you. As you mentioned,
thank you.
This is a time for all of us to come together and help. But it is true that it has brought out a lot of positivity in India. India does kind of come together in a crisis, and there's no bigger crisis than this. There are so many examples of people helping each other, helping others. And the film fraternity, actors, directors, are really, really doing something. Isn't that a positive aspect to this crisis? It's wonderful to see.
Yes, that's absolutely wonderful. And I'm so glad that that is the case. You know, and in every community and in every industry, I'm sure there are enough people who are, there are so many people who need our help. Why particularly I think that this is important is that, you know, we are of the film fraternity. We can speak of the film fraternity. There are other people from, you know, I don't know, the service industries who can speak of that. But who is going to speak for the children? You know, and it's not something that, you know, people have pushed, I think, to the backs of their minds. So, you know, I think like Neha said earlier, if we can all come together and look beyond our own family, beyond our own community, beyond our own industry, you know, to the children of India, to the future citizens of India, and, you know, help that generation. The trauma that they must be going through right now, and it's going to affect, you know, India for, you know, decades to come. I think this is the correct time for all of us to kind of, you know, rally together, join hands, and in whatever little way we can, we have to help our future citizens.
Excellent, yeah.
Excellent. Konkana, you said, who will speak about the children? Well, we will. Everyone will.
Yes.
there will be a community, and this community will get larger. Please do show that you care. The details right there on your screen right now. Please do donate, because this is going to help a child. Manish,
no, Sanket, and Anjali, I really feel already there's a kind of emotional reaction to this, that it has struck a chord, that children have in need, people are responding. It's wonderful.
Children. It's the fact that there is a basic human instinct that you can't see children like this. I think it's very, very significant. Right. And it's so good to see that India has a heart. Yeah. Manish Pasi, he's the MD of the Mini Club, he sent this message for us.
We as a brand love babies. We take utmost care, responsibility in making them look fashionable. We'd like to extend the same love, care and responsibility by joining hand with Save the Children team to contribute for the cause in helping the children on the street. We appreciate the efforts made by Government of India, healthcare workers and local bodies who all come together to fight the situation and help the ones who are in need. During this tough time, we need to help the most vulnerable ones. We are positive that we can fight this situation together and overcome it soon.
और इस वक्त हमारे साथ मिथाली राज जुड़ गई हैं, फॉर्मर कैप्टन हैं इंडियन क्रिकेट टीम की. मिथाली, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. और एक और खास मेहमान है मिथाली हमारे साथ, लूसी हैं, चैंपियन है वो, चाइल्ड चैंपियन. आप उनको बहुत अच्छे तरीके से जानती हैं, उनकी जर्नी को भी आप जानती हैं. लूसी ने बहुत बड़े बड़े कारनामे किए हैं. वो लॉर्ड्स में स्ट्रीट चिल्ड्रन के क्रिकेट टूर्नामेंट में जा चुकी हैं, वो ब्रिटिश पार्लियामेंट में जा चुकी हैं, बहुत कुछ उन्होंने किया है. लूसी, आपसे हम बात करेंगे कुछ देर में, पहले मिथाली से बात कर लेते हैं. मिथाली, आपको कैसा लगता है कि जब ये बच्चे अपने हाथों में इस जिम्मेदारी को ले लेते हैं, जो शायद हम लोगों को करनी चाहिए, इनकी मदद करना, इनके जैसे बच्चों की मदद करना, जब वो इतनी बड़ी जिम्मेदारी उठाते हैं तो हमें उनसे क्या सीखना चाहिए?
मेरी जो एसोसिएशन है सेव द चिल्ड्रन एज अ गुडविल एम्बेसडर, लास्ट ईयर अप्रैल में एज एम्बेसडर फॉर टीम इंडिया और फर्स्ट एवर स्ट्रीट चाइल्ड क्रिकेट वर्ल्ड कप के लिए था. और मैंने लूसी और उनके जो टीममेट्स हैं सोनी, आयुष्मान, इनसे मिली थी. तो मुझे उनके फेस में इतनी एक्साइटमेंट दिखा कि जब उनको ये अपॉर्चुनिटी मिला लॉर्ड्स जाके खेलने का, क्रिकेट मैच खेलने का, इट वाज अ मिक्स जेंडर क्रिकेट मैच. और जब मेरी मुलाकात उनसे हुई है तो मुझे ये सीखने को मिला कि इन बच्चों में भी ड्रीम्स है, इनकी एस्पिरेशंस है. इनको अगर हम सही अपॉर्चुनिटीज, एक्सपोजर दें, एजुकेशन दें. अगर मैं एजुकेशन की बात करती हूँ, ये बच्चे ने मुझे सेल्फ मेड एक कार्ड दिया था जिनमें इन्होंने इंग्लिश में लिखा था और उन्होंने कैसे उनकी एक्साइटमेंट, उनकी हैप्पीनेस रिप्रेजेंट करने का इंडिया को उस कैटेगरी में. तो मुझे लगता है इनको ये सही मौके देंगे तो ये इनके ड्रीम्स, इनके एस्पिरेशंस को अचीव कर सकते हैं. और इनमें भी सिंपल ख्वाहिशें हैं, सिंपल चीजों से बहुत खुश हो जाते हैं.
जी,
ये बहुत बड़ी बात है. एक चीज मैं और बता दूं, आपने शायद जाने अनजाने में, मेरे ख्याल क्रिकेट आप बहुत ज्यादा नहीं देखती हैं, वो फॉर्मर कैप्टन नहीं है, उनका बल्ला अभी भी चल रहा है.
ये तो मुझसे बहुत बड़ी गलती होगी, माफ कीजिए, क्रिकेट मेरी कमजोरी है.
उनका बड़प्पन है, उन्होंने ये चीज बोली नहीं. लेकिन मिथाली, मैं आपसे
बहुत बड़ी गलती,
मैं अभी आप हमारे साथ बने रहिए, क्योंकि लूसी जिसका जिक्र आपने किया था वो भी हमारे साथ फोन पर अभी है. लूसी, मिथाली राज जो है वो आपकी काफी तारीफ कर रही है, वो कह रही है कि एक एक्साइटमेंट था, दिखा था. मैं आपसे जानना चाहता हूं कि आपका अनुभव कैसा रहा है, योर एक्सपीरियंस.
वो कह रही है कि
मेरा एक्साइटेड बहुत अच्छा रहा, क्योंकि मिथाली मैम से मिलना, क्योंकि हम लोग सोच भी नहीं सकते कि उनसे मिलेंगे. हम तो सोचते थे क्योंकि वो इंडियन क्रिकेट के वुमेन्स क्रिकेटर थी, कैप्टन, तो इससे उनसे मिलकर ये हौसला आया कि लड़कियां भी कुछ कर सकती है. तो वो जब हम उनको देखे थे कि हाँ, मिथाली राज जब बन सकती है मैम तो हम भी कुछ कर सकते हैं, तो हमारे यहाँ भी लड़कियां भी कुछ कर सकती है, हमारे पास भी वो कैपेसिटी है जो मिथाली मैम ने कर दिया, एक दिन हम भी वो ऐसा करके दिखाएंगे.
मिथाली, आप कुछ कहना चाहेंगी लूसी को इस कार्यक्रम के माध्यम से?
मुझे लगता है कि जब ये बच्चों को इतनी कम अपॉर्चुनिटीज मिलते उसमें ही वो लोग इतना बड़ी चीजें हासिल कर सकते हैं. लूसी, इनफैक्ट लूसी को देखे मुझे इंस्पिरेशन होती है, मुझे मोटिवेशन होती है कि लिमिटेड रिसोर्सेज से वो फिर भी अपने ड्रीम्स को अचीव करने की कोशिश करते हैं.
मिताली, दिस इज प्रणॉय हियर. यू नो दैट आई एम एन एब्सोल्यूट क्रिकेट फैनेटिक,
अनलाइक मी
एंड एग्जैक्टली लाइक अंजलि, बट आई एम अ क्रिकेट फैनेटिक एंड यू आर एन एब्सोल्यूट इंस्पिरेशन टू ऑल ऑफ अस. व्हाट यू हैव डन इज जस्ट अमेजिंग. And when you look at the youngsters, the young boys and girls in particular in India, doesn't it fill you full of hope and excitement?
It does, sir, because at one point when women's cricket was not seen as a career option, today I see a lot of young kids like Lucy and Sony are also aspiring to become cricketers, aspiring to become women cricketers or be part of this sport. And also see the recognition of women's cricket around the world. In India, young boys not only look up to, say, the male counterparts, but they also know a lot of female cricketers or they follow women cricketers. So I think it's great to see that the boys and girls are they are looking at this sport as a career.
Right, it's wonderful that you're encouraging it. Thank you so much. And joining us now, we've got Sanjay Malik, Senior Vice President and Head of India Market, Nokia Solutions and Networks. Thank you very much for joining us. The focus on children is particularly important because there's this general feeling, oh, that the corona doesn't really affect younger people, but it's affected them socially. They're abandoned, they're in a worse condition than they've ever been. Is that what has motivated you to come on and try and do something about it?
Yeah, thank you very much, Pranay, and thank you for hosting me on this program.
You're welcome.
First of all,
thank you for
first
coming.
Of all, thank you very much to you and your team for putting together such a nice program for this social cause. Yeah, I think see, one of the big asset which India has is its demographics and its kind of youth population, and that is the strength which is there today, and we want to make sure that we protect that strength for future, and that's the reason that underprivileged children and the other children have to be supported today to make sure that we protect our future going forward. So yeah, from Nokia perspective, I would say that during this crisis time, we are basically contributing to the society in two ways. And I will come to your question also regarding the underprivileged children, but in two ways we are supporting it. One is that, you know, Nokia stands for connecting people, and we are kind of number one in providing all the network gears to all the operators these days. So as of now, we have about 1,000 people who are there on the road in maintaining this network, making this keep on running this network, so that you and we can talk and we can work from home as we are doing.
So you're connecting people with social distancing.
Yeah, so oh, connecting people with social distancing, and it's not only the video calls, it's basically connecting the students on for the virtual classroom, connecting people for remote medical health, which is again a very much a need today. So that's what
wonderful.
We are doing.
Thank you.
Thank yeah, so much. I think we want to make sure that remains.
That's a great message. And, you know, these sort of messages from people like you will get everybody motivated, inspired to donate and contribute to Save the Children. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you. God
Sanjay
bless
Ji
you.
For joining us right here. And speaking of people who motivate, Rahul Ram, he's a singer of the Indian Ocean is now
great.
With us. He's surprised that I said that he motivates. Of course you do, Rahul. You motivate through
Thank
your
you.
Songs. This cause, Rahul, this cause, ye jo hum log ye jo initiative hai yahan par, Save the Children, bachchon ko aksar bhool jate hain, wo adrishya ho jate hain. Aapko bhi lagta hai aise hi?
Ye dekhiye, aisa hai ki log
कॉन्शियसली नहीं करते हैं, मगर ऐसे बहुत सारे चीजें, जैसे आप अगर नेशनल डिस्कोर्स या डिबेट में देखिए, बच्चों को तो भूलते ही हैं हम लोग, जैसे आदिवासियों को भी भूल जाते हैं, क्योंकि जो हमारा फोकस है इतना आजकल आगे बढ़ने ये वो पे हो गया है। अब जो पैंडेमिक आया है इससे आप देख सकते हो कि मैं, जैसे मेरी वाइफ काम करती है स्ट्रीट डॉग्स के साथ, जब वो बाहर जाती है तो यहां वहां से बच्चे आ जाते हैं गाड़ी देख के कि खाना आप दे रहे हैं, शायद आप खाना बांट रहे हो। हमको दिखता है हर दिन कि लोग बच्चे खास करके यहां से वहां भाग रहे हैं कि उन्हें कुछ मिल जाए। और मुझे लगता है कि आप लोग जैसे कर रहे हो बच्चों के लिए, ये बहुत ही नेसेसरी है और बहुत ही अच्छा काम कर रहे हो। बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया एनडीटीवी कि आप लोगों ने हमारे देश के बच्चों के लिए इस टाइम पे ये टेलीथॉन ऑर्गेनाइज किया है। बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया।
थैंक यू सो मच।
इस वक्त बहुत अच्छी खुशखबरी ये है कि हम लोगों ने 1,10,00,000 से ज्यादा जमा कर लिया। थैंक यू वेरी मच राहुल, आपकी भी इसमें योगदान है। आप ये हमारे साथ जो भी जुड़े उन सब ने इसमें योगदान दिया। एक बहुत अच्छी खबर इस वक्त ये है। और एक ये के संदेश,
मैं आपसे संदेश मिल चुका यार, 1,10,00,000, 1,10,00,000 तो रेज हुए हैं और भी रेज कर देना यार।
Yes, we're just starting.
हमारा देश इतना बड़ा है
जी।
एक्सेलेंट,
थैंक यू
एंड आई विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट।
लगता है ठीक ठाक डेमोक्रेसी है।
एग्जैक्टली,
हाँ ठीक ठाक।
थैंक
यू वेरी मच,
थैंक यू। और अब हम ये संदेश चलाना चाहते हैं। सुमित है, वो भी एक चाइल्ड चैंपियन है जिसने एक रैप सॉन्ग बनाया है। तो आइए सुनते हैं कि वो क्या गाना है।
बात पे मेरी गौर करो ना, बात पे मेरी गौर करो ना, ये है कोरोना, ये है कोरोना, बात पे मेरी गौर करो ना, ये है कोरोना, ये है कोरोना, इससे डरो ना, हाथ को धोना, घर पे ही रहना, घर पे ही सोना, घर पे ही रहना, घर पे ही सोना, पढ़ सकता जिंदगी का रोना, ये है कोरोना, ये है कोरोना। कही गई बातों को अपनाना है, देश का नागरिक बन के दिखाना है, जल्दी से कोरोना भगाना है, जल्दी से कोरोना भगाना है। सोशल डिस्टेंस एंड हैंड वॉश, सोशल डिस्टेंस एंड हैंड वॉश, सोशल डिस्टेंस एंड हैंड वॉश, जल्दी से हमें कोरोना बीमारी से बचना है तो कही गई बातों को अपनाना होगा। बात पे मेरी गौर करो ना, ये है कोरोना, ये है कोरोना, बात पे मेरी गौर करो ना, ये है कोरोना, ये है कोरोना, इससे डरो ना, 20 सेकंड हाथों को धोना, घर पे ही रहना, घर पे ही सोना, घर पे ही रहना, घर पे ही सोना, किसी से हाथ ना मिलाना है, बस दूर से सर को झुकाना है, डॉक्टर पुलिस का साथ भी निभाना है, जल्दी से कोरोना भगाना है, जल्दी से कोरोना भगाना है, देश को फिर से स्वस्थ बनाना है, देश को फिर से स्वस्थ बनाना है। Stay home and save life, 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 stay home and save life.
Well, that's wonderful. He's actually performed in one of our earlier telethons. He's just amazing. Mm-hmm. Just very quickly, I want to just bring an update on what's happening on the coronavirus front in India. Just a quick update, and this is what it looks like. If you look at the All India graphic, and we've shown this before, but let's do an update. The cases now at the lowest level since the lockdown started. You know, it was at the peak, it was doubling at about every 2 days or 3 days. That was a really, really worrying period. Now it's flattened for the last few days. And in fact, number of cases is doubling every 10 days. That is a very good sign. But that's not the whole story. And that's what we should not be complacent about. Doubling every 10 days, what does that really mean? Let's have a look. If you have a look at what it means for the future, if we move on to the next graphic, it'll just give you the implication. Currently, it looks under control, but could be more worrying future. no room for complacency at the moment. If India manages even to keep at this rate, in 1 month from now, you will have 2 lakh cases. And at the end of June, that's just over 2 months from now, you'll have 22 lakh cases. So just, you know, don't take what you've got now for granted. And the total number of deaths 1 month from now at this rate would be 6,700, nearly 7,000. And after, at the end of June, if this rate continues, and let's pray it doesn't, so no complacency, 72,000 deaths. That is really the kind of frightening future we're looking at. In fact, the number of deaths per day will go up if this rate continues, up to 440 deaths per day in 1 month from now, and nearly 5,000 deaths per day at the end of June. Now, 5,000 deaths a day is something we cannot accept. And do not take this flattening at doubling every 10 days as a great sign. And let me show you how much even worse it could be. A little slip from 10 days to 8 days. It doubles every 8 days, say. And look what happens. At the end of a month, you'll have 3.6 lakh cases. And at the end of June, 74 lakh cases, if that rate continues. The end, you'll have 12,000 in 1 month, 12,000 deaths. And at the end of June, almost 2.5 lakh deaths. I'm just showing these figures. These are just data, nothing to do with me. So at the end of a month, nearly 1,000 deaths per day. And at the end of June, you could get over 20,000 deaths a day. Now, all I'm saying is no room for complacency. And this is assuming that our death rate is still at 3.1 compared to the global average of near 7. We're less than half the global average in death rate. So we've just got to stop this. We cannot be happy with a doubling every 10 days. We've got to bring it down, 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 and make sure this thing peters out fast. Those are worrying figures, and just keep them in mind. Let's hope they never happen, but they just do not underestimate this virus.
And I think that was the message of the Prime Minister also today in his Mann Ki Baat, where he said, do not take this lightly.
Yes.
Don't take
yes.
this lightly, and that's the reason why, which has been explained on the screen right now. All right, moving on now. Thank you so much, Dr. Roy, for that explanation. This is very, very significant.
It's not to be alarmist, it's just to say don't be complacent.
Don't be complacent, absolutely. We have Tahira Kashyap now with us. Tahira Kashyap is a very significant player, and she feels very strongly about this initiative, is now with us. Tahira, good to have you on the show. Can you tell us what really should be done or can be done at an individual level for these invisible children? I know for a fact that you feel very strongly.
Yes, absolutely. I feel very strongly about and for the children. And just like I was just listening to Dr. Roy, he was telling us about statistics and he was telling us about how things could double up and how we should not be complacent. In a sense, I feel he's talking about the causes that we're creating right now, that we should create the correct causes to reap the right effects. And that's what I even lend to this cause for the children. They are the future for our nation. They are our future. What causes are we creating? How are we protecting the youth? And whatever steps we're taking right now, be sure that that's what a future is going to be like. That's the effect that is going to be. So if you think that they are being nurtured, nourished well enough, they are being protected, we're looking at a very bright future for us. But in case if that's not the case, which is happening, that we really need to think twice about it. And I really want to thank you all for bringing forth this initiative. And I would like and request all the people to donate as much as they can, because children do matter. And in such times, they are going under even more difficult circumstances. The schools are shut for a lot of kids. They one big meal used to be from the schools, the midday meals, and even that's shut. A lot of kids face not just problems when it comes to food and shelter, but they have they experience physical abuse. And at this point of time, they are locked down with the abusers. So we really, really need to protect and nourish the child, the children, the youth. And I would really, really appeal to everyone
to donate as much as they can.
That's just wonderful to hear that. Thank you very much. And, you know, as you mentioned, children are going through a tough time. And it's particularly, there's so many lakhs and lakhs of the poorest children who have been abandoned. And they're just on the streets. They used to be employed by an employer and illegally, but he's run away because he's scared after the lockdown. So a lot of them are just at the worst suffering right now.
Absolutely.
We should all reach out to those who are the poorest, right?
We should. And honestly speaking, of course, the idea is to make the invisible visible. But I think the onus really lies on us because they are visible. I stay in a place called, I'm in Mumbai. So here where we share a locality, there are towering buildings. And at the same time, you see the slums too. So it's not that they are amiss. It's not that they're into the hiding. They are there. We have turned a blind eye and a deaf ear to them. So we should really become uncomfortable with the fact that this is how the children are living. The day we become uncomfortable, right now, I think we need to be more sensitized. We are very comfortable with seeing the children be treated how they are. We see it on a daily basis. I think a lot of the prerogative and the initiative lies within us, and we need to sort of become uncomfortable with the situation.
Wonderful. Thank you very much. I could clearly see the emotion involved in every word that you said there. Thank you very much, for joining us. We're also very fortunate to have Malini Sabha join us, chairman of the Sabha Group of Companies. Thank you very, very much for joining us. This is an issue that is very close to your heart, isn't it, Malini?
Yes, it is. It is. I think the children, as my colleague who said earlier, are usually the last to be heard. And I think it's important that we all come together and raise as much money as we can to help both the kids who are, you know, in homes and the kids who are not in homes, because they're all in a bad situation at the moment.
Very bad, yes. And you know, there is so much talent and potential amongst our children of this country. You know, we have people coming to lecture us from all over the world, and when they meet the children in India, they say they haven't met such hungry, in terms of wanting something better in life than they've met in India. They've traveled all over the world, and the potential of the Indian youngster is the greatest. And we are really treating them badly right now.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think that, you know, having lived around the world and worked with a lot of children, I do agree with you. I think there's a fire in the belly with the Indian child, and the need and the desire for knowledge and for betterment. And
desire
we
for
need
knowledge,
to
yeah.
keep, yeah, and we need to keep that burning, because the intellectual property in India is enormous, and we must never ever forget that.
Now, I have just this most amazing message from you. I just can't even believe this. It's just so wonderful to read. That you will match whatever is raised, whatever money is raised, you will match it. I mean,
yes.
That is so moving.
Yes, sir, we will. And again, it's a matter very close to my heart. I believe that the children are our future, and it is our responsibility as adults to create a clear path for them, that we don't end up in the situations that we are in at the moment. It is our responsibility. So yes, it is. I'm passionate about it.
Passion is a huge gesture too. For every rupee we raise, you put in a rupee, is just wonderful, isn't it? Isn't it just
absolutely
amazing?
Absolutely.
It's just God bless you for your passion and for wanting to do something about it. Thank you.
Thank you
again. Last words to everybody on how to get involved in this particular focus of children and making, and they're the forgotten children, how to make them visible again.
Right.
Absolutely. Mere khayal se ye bahut hi noble gesture tha Sabha Group of Companies ki taraf se.
That's huge.
Sivakumar ji, Dr. Sivakumar is an economist, is now with us. Dr. Sivakumar, thank you so much for joining us. the financial impact of this lockdown is something that we have discussed over a very long time. We've been continuously doing. It's the emotional impact and also the mental impact on the children, and in effect, what the impact it has on the economy subsequently is something which is absolutely silent. I don't think people talk about this enough or don't even know about it enough.
Yeah. You know, I completely agree with you when you talk about making the invisible visible. There are two dimensions that have got sort of sidelined in the discourse on providing more food, shelter, cash and so on, which are extremely vital for the nutritional well-being of children and avoiding hunger and starvation. One is really the mental well-being of children. And many experts will tell you that when there is forced confinement and lockdown, this leads to a lot of anxiety disorders. And these often take the form of maybe headaches, muscle pain, body aches, disruption of sleep patterns. And this goes quite unnoticed, but has a very telling effect on a child's behavior and growth over the times. Also, when you do this, you know, when you're forced to stay confined, restrained with no social interaction, it also breeds aggressive behaviors. So I think this looking at mental well-being in addition to physical well-being and health is an extremely important dimension that we need to factor in.
You know, to describe you as an economist is a little bit of an understatement, because you've worked on social policy all your life and you focused on children and women. That's been your main area of focus. So I would say that as an economist, this specialization makes you understand the plight that children are in today much better than others.
Thank you, Pranoy. And that's what I'm trying to say. In addition to increasing allocations for generally health and particularly for children, we also need to allocate very significant resources for addressing the mental well-being. By the way, there is also this expression called quarantines, which means that teenagers who are also forced into this kind of lockdown with loss of privacy have their own set of anxieties. Children who are finishing school are not sure on what is going to happen in terms of college admissions. So this, with pressure from parents to perform well in schools, there's a lot of concern among young children as well. And finally, I want to add that, yes, we are doing homeschooling to the extent possible, but there's a large segment of children who may not have that kind of privileged access to homeschooling via Zoom and Skype and so on and so forth. So the disruption in their learning is going to be quite severe, and this kind of lack of educational attainment is an educational injustice that we certainly need to factor in and address, both in terms of the resource allocations that need to be increased for school education, but also right. specifically focusing on the needs of underprivileged and poor, vulnerable children.
Right, and it's a great investment for the future of this country. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you, Dr. Sivik Kumar.
Thank you.
Sankit, great to be. अगर yeah. एक मिनट ले सकूं, एक अच्छी खबर ये भी आई है कि अभिषेक खेड़िया, उन्होंने एक मुजाटो के जरिए एक पेंटिंग खरीदी है और 33,000 रुपए से 33,000 से भी ज्यादा की उन्होंने पेंटिंग खरीदी और वो कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट कर रहे हैं उसके जरिए हमारे इस कॉज में.
Every little drop counts at this moment, because there should be light. Let there be light in the lives of these children. And speaking of light, Daniel Maison, you're the CEO of Philips India, is now with us. Daniel, good to have you on this show. I want to know from you how strongly should corporates be feeling about an initiative like this? Because, see, as the name suggests of this presentation, they're invisibles.
Yeah, so looks, first of all, thanks for having me here. This is a privilege to be able to be participating in your show and in this important event. I think corporates have to be all in. I mean, this is the moment that we have to show what we're made out of. And Philips, as an example, we've done a couple of different things, but just in October of last year, Philips India and the foundation has joined hands with Save the Children to develop an affordable initiative for prevention, diagnosis, and management of pneumonia. This is a project that in the next 2 years will deliver high-quality pneumonia care to children under 5 years old across the two worst states affected in the country. We're very proud of leveraging technology, diagnostic tools, you know, training, educating the frontline teams in such need.
Absolutely, and we would also like to highlight a few more contributions that are coming in, Daniel, right now. We just spoke to Malini Sabha, and we've just got to know that she's also donating 20 tons of rice, and this will be procured through their, India partners, Navbharat. And this is a contribution apart from what she just promised us.
Massive. Wow, fantastic. That is just really, really moving.
Absolutely. Would you like to go to Daniel again?
I believe in just a short moment from now, we'll have Huma Qureshi also with us. But Daniel, let me quickly come back to you. You were talking about the role that the corporates can play at this moment, and they have to be all in. I don't know if I heard you correctly. You said that they have to be all in.
Yes.
Now, when you say all in, I mean, one is, of course, you know, the larger initiative of donating for PM CARES and you know, using your own corporate social responsibility funds. But apart from that, specifically on issues like these, targeted issues like for the welfare of children, what do you think can actually be done? The role that corporates can play?
So can you hear me okay? The sound coming across all right?
Yeah, we can hear you just fine. Please go.
Great. So specific to the COVID, we've been dealing with this quite early on all over the world, right? The Philips Foundation has provided immediate support for prevention and treatment at a global level. Of course, it started in China, moved to Kenya, many other countries, but here in India particularly, besides increasing, quadrupling the output of diagnostic products, respiratory disease products, Philips is also extended support to states that are focusing on tracking hands-on management of the spread of the virus. We're working local level through financial distributions, contributions, and donations of PPEs and supplies, and working with NGOs. And then, just so you know, I'm extremely proud to share that on behalf of Philips India employer today, we are pledging also a contribution of 5 lakh towards food and basic needs for street children. The Save the Children program. We believe that, as you mentioned before, every drop counts, and Philips will do more in the coming days to continue support this cause impacted all of us across the world.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Daniel.
Thank you for
being part of this. Also, someone who's been part of this all along, of course, Save the Children. They are the ones who are powering this entire program. And Bidisha Pillai is still with us. Bidisha, hum ye puri charcha karte rahe lagatar, aur sab yahan pe jo aa rahe hain, wo is baat ko ab mere khayal se samajh gaye hain ki bachche jinke bare mein hum aksar sochna bhool jate hain, aur wo जिनके सोचने के लिए कोई उनका अपना नहीं है, उनका अब उन पर ध्यान देना बेहद जरूरी हो गया. और जिस तरह से लोग अभी बढ़कर सामने आ रहे हैं, आप उनके लिए क्या कहना चाहेंगे? क्योंकि जिस तरह की कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन आ रही हैं, वो काफी काबिले तारीफ है.
I have to say that we are feeling so, so grateful. This is beyond our expectation. I think I feel so humbled and so proud. I will, you know, on several counts. One, I will forget to thank every single person. So I just want to say thank you to all our donors and contributors, big, small, everything. But also for all the spokespersons who've come so far. I mean, it's wonderful how they've actually understood the issue. My job is much easier. Mujhe kehne ki kuch zarurat hi nahi hai. So it's been absolutely humbling. And I really agree with Rahul Ram when he says ki matlab, दिल तो हमारा समंदर ही है. आई थिंक इंडिया इज रियली शाइनिंग एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम एंड कमिंग फॉरवर्ड टू प्रोटेक्ट दैट जनरेशन.
Yes,
wonderful.
Yes, Bidisha, you know, we'll continue this conversation, but Dr. Roy, there is this question I want to ask you about the graphics that you had shown us earlier. They are extremely sobering graphics, I must say. The data, as you said, we're not trying to be alarmist, but it does put you in a situation where you start considering what is going to happen. Do you think there is some way through which the number that you are giving in the last section every time, whether it's 74 or 22 lakhs, will that be will it happen that that won't happen? We will not see those numbers, or it will happen? It's inevitable.
You see, the issue is that we are in a lockdown and we're at the lowest level of the lockdown. So the negatives and positives. Negatives, when you raise the lockdown and relax it a bit, the rate may go up, which could be terrible. On the other hand, there are all kinds of other factors that people are talking about, temperature, ultraviolet rays, but these are not yet established. There's a research study done that says it has an impact, but it's not been peer-reviewed, so it's not sure.
The vaccines
But the main thing is, you know, it's come down to this level of doubling every 10 days, and we think, wow, you know, from doubling every 2 days to every 10 days, we've done it. No. If it carries on like this, we're in deep trouble. We've got to get it down to even lower, you know, doubling every 20 days, 30 days, 50 days, like Kerala's done. Doubling every 70 days.
Correct.
That is
correct.
What we have to aim at.
Also, we have to realize, see, when you double from 1,000 to 2,000, that's less ground to cover. But then when you double from 10,000 to 20,000,
exactly.
That is a greater ground to cover, but the number of days taken should also be factored in.
I think done well so far, but that is just the beginning of the story.
Again, I reiterate the Prime Minister's words, do not take this lightly. India cannot take this lightly. He has a meeting with the Chief Ministers also tomorrow. Vijender Singh, Indian professional boxer, ab hamare saath jud gaye hain. Vijender, kaise mukka maar maar ke is virus ko bhagaya jaye bhai?
Sir, main keh raha hu mukke se kaam nahi chalega, lath nikalna padega iske liye to.
Bilkul mukke se kaam nahi chal raha, haath dhone se kaam chal raha hai.
हाँ, धो के पीछे पड़ना पड़ेगा. पंच से तो फिर कोरोना फैलता है, तो एक लठ लेके आओ बड़ा सा हरियाणा में, और उससे दूर से ही धुनाई करो इसकी, तभी ठीक रहेगा.
And he wears gloves all the time, so it's a good example.
Yeah, he wears it. That's a good. I mean, you talk about professional hazard.
Sometimes opponent is very crazy, sir. He trying to hold me or he trying to push me down, but you have to be like, you know, stay away from him.
Right. Vijender, एक सवाल मैं आपसे पूछना चाहता था. ये जो initiative है, ये है save the children, making the invisibles visible. जो अदृश्य हैं, उनको सामने लाना, उनकी पीड़ा जो है, उसको उजागर करना. मैं आपसे ये जानना चाहता हूं कि क्या आप भी मानते हैं हमारी तरह कि ये एक ऐसा पहलू है, एक मानवीय पहलू, जिसके बारे में बहुत ज्यादा बात नहीं होती, शायद इसलिए क्योंकि कोरोना का वक्त है, इतनी बड़ी दुनिया की सारे देश इसमें लगे हुए हैं, वैश्विक महामारी है, तो जाहिर सी बात है ये एक छोटी बात हो जाती है और छोटी बात होकर के दब जाती है, लेकिन बात छोटी है नहीं.
That's true, sir. बात बहुत बड़ी है. बात हमारे जो बच्चे हैं, जो हमारा भविष्य है, जो इंडिया का, उनके बारे में है. बिकॉज जो मैं आपकी न्यूज में मैंने देखी, आई फॉलो किया, मैं उसमें तकरीबन 20 से 25 लाख जो बच्चे हैं वो सड़कों पे हैं, तो इट्स नॉट अ स्मॉल थिंग, बहुत बड़ी बात है. और इसके लिए इनिशिएटिव जरूर लेना चाहिए, कहते महामारी अपनी जगह, लेकिन उनकी हेल्थ भी बहुत जरूरी है, और इसके लिए सरकार को जरूर से जरूर कहते जरूरी कदम उठाने चाहिए. दैट्स व्हाट आई थिंक. And that's what I believe.
जी बिल्कुल. और विजेंद्र, आपने जो तरीका सिखाया, भले ही देसी हो, लेकिन मेरे ख्याल से वो फिजिकल डिस्टेंसिंग की बात जरूर हमें सिखा देता है. इसके लिए बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. एक डंडा अगर आप मारने के लिए इस्तेमाल ना भी करें, तो एक डंडा एक तरह से मेजर करने के लिए इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं कि कितनी दूरी किसी से बना के रखनी है. शुक्रिया आपका. हमारे साथ इस वक्त कुछ और मेहमान भी जुड़ रहे हैं. हुमा कुरैशी हमारे साथ जुड़ गई हैं, अभिनेत्री. बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आपका हुमा. आपके लिए ये कॉज नया नहीं है, आप सेव द चिल्ड्रन के साथ जुड़ी रही हैं, आप उनके साथ नेपाल भी गई थी, बहुत कुछ आप पहले भी इसकी अवेयरनेस के लिए कर चुकी हैं. आपको क्यों लगता है कि बच्चों के ऊपर खास ध्यान इस वक्त देना जरूरी है? क्योंकि कुछ लोग ये कह सकते हैं इस वक्त कि देयर आर बिगर इश्यूज इन द वर्ल्ड, क्यों इस वक्त हाशिए पे जो बच्चे हैं उनके ऊपर हमें ध्यान देना जरूरी है?
फॉर हैविंग मी ऑन द शो. सबसे पहले तो आई डोंट नो कि बच्चों से ज्यादा जरूरी चीज क्या हो सकती है. यू नो, आई थिंक दे आर द फ्यूचर ऑफ आर कंट्री, दे आर द फ्यूचर ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड. तो अगर आप उन पे ध्यान नहीं देंगे, और सबसे सेंसिटिव जो एक ग्रुप है, यू नो, वो बच्चे हैं, क्योंकि वो खुद को
यू नो दे डिपेंड ऑन अस, दे डिपेंड ऑन द एडल्ट्स, और खासकर जो बच्चे जो होमलेस हैं, जो कि यू नो किसी भी वजह से यू नो स्ट्रीट्स पे रहते हैं, वो बहुत ही ज्यादा इस वक्त इन दिस सिचुएशन दे आर इन अ स्टेट ऑफ बीइंग वेरी वेरी वल्नरेबल. सो वी हैव टू रियली डू समथिंग एंड प्रोटेक्ट देम. दिस इज रियली आवर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू रियली प्रोटेक्ट दीज किड्स.
एब्सोल्युटली.
हुमा, मैं आपसे ये जानना चाहता था कि आप सेलिब्रिटी हैं, बहुत सारे और भी सेलिब्रिटीज इस कॉज के साथ जुड़े हैं इस इनिशिएटिव के द्वारा. आपको क्या लगता है कि सरकार और नीति क्या बन सकती है अभी इस वक्त? मैं बार बार एक चीज दोहरा रहा हूं इस कार्यक्रम के माध्यम से कि अभी क्योंकि इतना ओवरवेलमिंग है ये कोरोना वायरस लॉकडाउन, तो सारा फोकस सारा दिमाग उसी से निपटने में लग जाता है और हम अक्सर ये छोटी छोटी चीजें भूल जाते हैं जो कि छोटी नहीं है. तो किस किस्म की नीति और किस किस्म का दबाव सरकार पे बनाया जा सकता है?
सब लोग जानते हैं ऑफ कोर्स यू नो एज द रिसर्च इज गोइंग ऑन, कोविड-19 जो है जो खासकर बच्चे हैं और जो थोड़े से बुजुर्ग उम्र के लोग हैं उनको ज्यादा अफेक्ट करता है बिकॉज द इम्यूनिटी इज रियली लो. एंड हमने बहुत दफे देखा है जो हमारे अर्बन सिटीज हैं उसमें बहुत सारे यू नो ऐसी पॉपुलेशन है जो सिर्फ रोड के ऊपर रहती है. नाउ सडनली because of social distancing, because of lockdown, you don't see them anywhere. So where have those children gone? And they really are the most vulnerable right now. They could be the biggest carriers. They could get really affected. Or I don't think kis kism ka hum mulk khud ko kahenge agar hum apne bachchon ko apne future ka dhyan na rakh paye. So I think they are a really, really, you know, sensitive group that we really have to work extra towards. There's another I have been working for with many years, Jamghat करके एक organization है street के बच्चों के लिए जो कि खासकर काम करते हैं उन बच्चों के साथ, तो या तो घर से भागे हुए हैं या बिछड़ गए अपने माँ बाप से और वो street पे रहते हैं. उनमें से बहुत सारे बच्चे ऐसे हैं जो कि you know for whatever reason you know they could be exposed to drug use or they could be exposed to abuse. और खासकर जब भी कोई pandemic जैसी situation आती है उस वक्त पे ये बच्चे जो हैं वो खास करके बहुत ज्यादा you know sensitive हो जाते हैं towards this disease. तो अगर हमको वाकई ही अपनी you know if our biggest concern is कि हम लोग globally कैसे COVID-19 को रोके, तो we cannot ignore and you know cannot not protect these children. I think that's really really important.
ये बहुत बड़ी बात कह रही हैं. हुमा, हमारे साथ बने रहिए क्योंकि आपने ये जो बात एक उठाई यहाँ पर इस कार्यक्रम में वो बहुत ही अहम है कि वो बच्चे जो सड़कों पर दिख रहे थे, एक तो लोग ही नहीं दिख रहे हैं लेकिन वो जो बच्चे जो सड़कों पर थे अब वो सड़कों पर नहीं दिख रहे हैं, तो वो कहाँ हैं, किस बस्ती में हैं, किस हाल में हैं? हाँ हुमा, आप कुछ कहना चाह रही थी.
व्हाटएवर एक्टर आप जो भी कहें, यू नो हम लोग बहुत ज्यादा, मैं भी, हम लोग घर पे रहते हैं, बोर होते हैं, बहुत सारे वीडियो शेयर करते हैं कि आज मैंने ये बनाया, आज वो किया. कहीं कभी कभी मुझे लगता है कि यू नो हम कितने फॉर्चुनेट हैं और कितने ब्लेस्ड हैं कि आपकी सबसे बड़ी समस्या इस वक्त क्या है कि आप घर पे बैठ के बोर हो रहे हैं और आप अपना वो टाइम कैसे बिताएं. आप उन लोगों के पास सोचिए जिनके पास यू नो या तो बहुत छोटे घर हैं या घर है ही नहीं, तो वो लोग कहाँ इस वक्त हैं और वो क्या कर रहे हैं और वो कैसे. सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग इज ऑल्सो अ लग्जरी. इट्स ऑल्सो समथिंग दैट वी हैव, दैट यू हैव. पीपल हु आर वॉचिंग अवर शो राइट नाउ हैव. अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल डोंट हैव दैट लग्जरी एंड वी रियली हैव टू थिंक अबाउट देम.
Absolutely. I think I couldn't agree more. Social distancing is actually a luxury for those who can actually think of this. Vishal Agarwal now. Thank you so much, Huma, for joining us.
Thank you very much indeed.
Vishal Agarwal is the MD India and SARC of Avaya. Vishal, thank you so much for joining us. You must be hearing about this program. You must have heard what people are saying, what Huma said. Let me ask you this question again. What can be done? What comes to your mind when you think of these invisible children?
I think we have been very actively working on the social cost to our CSR contribution. What's really important for, and we have been partnering with Save the Children organization over the years, and at this point in time, contributing to these children who are homeless becomes the utmost priority. And from an Avaya perspective, which primarily focuses on technology transformation and collaboration, we are very effectively working with NGOs to provide them the technology platform to collaborate, communicate through video conferencing and other collaboration tools. So while we are contributing through our CSR and pledging to support the street kids, we are also making sure that we provide the technology platform to the NGOs in the country to make sure they work effectively with their ecosystem.
मेरे ख्याल से एक चीज यहाँ पर जिक्र, विशाल आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, एक चीज मैं यहाँ पर जरूर जिक्र करना चाहता हूँ, इससे पहले हम शीरीन वकील के पास जाएं। विशाल की जो कंपनी है अवाया, उसने उन्होंने 11 लाख रुपए डोनेट किए हैं इस कॉज के लिए। विशाल, एवरी पेनी मैटर्स एंड थैंक यू सो मच।
थैंक यू वेरी मच।
थैंक यू सो मच विशाल।
थैंक
यू। शीरीन वकील हैं, आप हेड हैं पॉलिसी एंड एडवोकेसी टाटा ट्रस्ट। Shireen is also with us. Thanks so much, Shireen, for joining us. I want to know from you, again, the same question. When you look at an initiative where people are at least talking about this, do you think that this could force the government to think along these lines? I mean, I'm not going to blame the government for not doing enough. For all you know, they are. But do you think that there is a vulnerability that kids are exposed to which must be highlighted? More so now?
Yes, I think definitely, and I think it's really great that NDTV is doing this in partnership with Save the Children. And children are vulnerable, I think, across the board. But street children in particular, as many people have mentioned, are extremely vulnerable. And I think one of the issues is they're on the streets, they're on the pavement, either with their families or without. And they're kind of last in line to get the help they need, whether it's food and other things, but also the fact that, not having school, not having any support services, and even reaching out to them. So the smaller NGOs who work do not have the passes to get to them, and they're not able to communicate their anxieties, their worries that they're facing right now.
राइट शरीन, एक और चीज जो अहम हो जाती है वो है एजुकेशन। इस वक्त एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम यू नो नॉट मेनी पीपल आर थिंकिंग अबाउट एजुकेशन ऑफ द स्ट्रीट चिल्ड्रन। वी मे बी थिंकिंग अबाउट द एजुकेशन ऑफ आर चिल्ड्रन, वी आर होम स्कूलिंग देम। हाउ एग्जैक्टली पॉलिसीज कैन बी फ्रेम्ड सो दैट दीज चिल्ड्रन हु आर प्रोबेबली गोइंग टू स्कूल्स दैट आर रन बाय गवर्नमेंट और एनजीओस, दे डू नॉट फॉल बिहाइंड बिकॉज दे आर द वंस हु नीड सपोर्ट द मोस्ट।
Yeah, I mean, I think education is a big issue for lots of children in the country. It's very few who can get the online homeschooling, in the urban centers. For a lot of rural India, it's going to be very difficult for the children. But given the fact that, we're sitting in national capital and there are about at least a lakh children who are on the streets, and it's really, really important that as the government frames policies for children, that these children are taken into account. And I think that is one of the things when we say about invisible, that they're not actually counted. Many of them do not have a kind of identity certificate, etc. So they just fall through the cracks. So it's very important. I mean, there are lots of NGOs working on the ground in small numbers, and a larger NGO like Save the Children can bring all these street children NGOs together and along in partnership with CSR, with the government, that a clear plan is made so that these kids are reached and they are counted. I think that was really important.
Right. Shireen, I must say that NDTV, like the rest of this country, have nothing but huge admiration for Tata Trust and the kind of work you do selflessly. And you yourself have worked for 20 years in child rights and child development. What would you say to a person watching? What can an ordinary individual do now to reach out and help these poorest children who are abandoned and who are in deep trouble at the moment?
I think to prioritize, I think the main thing is food. You know, I was speaking to a smaller NGO called Chetna, who works with street children, and they're not able to get to the kids. They know where they are, they're getting SMSs from the children, but they're just not able to get to them. So the transport is an issue. Many NGOs are not given passes. So I think the issue of actually making sure that these children, the street children, are reached with food and then with support, because they're subject to a lot of abuse. Anyway, even in normal times, they're very subject to physical abuse, even sexual abuse, both boys and, because there's a lot of boys on the street, and of course girls, as well as substance abuse. So I think it's very important that they are in shelters, they are safely looked after, and they do get the food to start with in this emergency situation.
All right, Shireen, many thanks. Thank you so much, and hope this initiative continues. Lakshmi Manchu, the Telugu actress, is now with us. Lakshmi, good to have you on the show. I wanted to ask you too the very same question that Huma was talking about, and I think that has kind of touched and moved me.
And also, let's just point out one thing here, Sanket. She's also involved in feeding the children herself. She's been taking care of some children around her house.
Let's first know about that. Lakshmi, would you like to tell us?
Sorry, I couldn't hear you. Can you repeat that again?
No, if you can hear me now, we know that you have taken some initiative of feeding children around you. Can you tell us about what they've told you?
I run GeoQuality for Change, and we teach in governance, English, and leadership qualities. And we've been doing this for over 6 years. And I realized that no matter what you're trying to do, like, no, food is the most important thing. It's not about not having the produce, but having money to buy the produce, give it to the kids. So we've reached out to about 5,000 families here in Telangana, around Hyderabad. That is, we are doing a Teach for Change. My father in Tirupati, where we have educational institutions, we have adopted 8 villages around Rangamitta, which is where we have our educational institutes. And this lockdown is over, so their essentials and food supplies are taken care of.
It's just great to hear you talk about this so that others can hear, be inspired, and try and do the same thing themselves. It's just fantastic. Hello, 8 villages and all those children. Fantastic.
We are truly inspired what you're doing and the initiative that you've taken up about saving the children, making the invisible visible. This is so important because the children don't suffer, and yet we are at war. And the best we can do is take care of the people who are right close to us. I mean, that is all. It's today what we can do for them, you know.
Fantastic. Wonderful.
Wonderful. Thank you. Lakshmi, thank you so much. And keep up this initiative. I believe we've got Bidisha Pillai back with us. Bidisha, I've been meaning to ask you this ever since Huma said what she did. She said that, you know, while you do see these children around when there was no lockdown, homeless children, where are they now? What are your experiences? Where are they? What are they doing? Who's taking care of them?
Yeah, so, you know, that's a really fair question. And that was the first thing that we did as well, reaching out to. So we are working with about 2.5 lakh children across the country. Now, some of them actually have gone back home, you know, with their families. But for the large numbers who were on the streets by themselves, as Amodji was mentioning, there are some shelters that have been set up by NGOs, by the government, because as NCPCR chairperson also said, that there is a directive. So at least there is a shelter that these children have been able to go to. Now, of course, you know, the kind of services available in these are of variable standards, but our attempt at this point of time is really to ensure that the basic needs, as even Shireen was saying, are met in terms of their hygiene, their sanitation and food, etc. But I think the bigger worry for us is, you know, when the lockdown is lifted, reintegrating them back, you know, because for many of them, they had been admitted to school, they were going to school, and now they have dropped out. And this gap is going to be hard for us to sort of make up. You know, it will need a renewed effort.
Right.
Similarly, on health and nutrition.
Okay.
Right.
Okay. We're going to come back to you, Bidisha. I believe there's some audio issue. We'll fix that and come back. Vasvi Bharatram, Joint Vice President of the Shriram Schools and also a member of the board of Save the Children is now with us. Vasvi, good to have you on the show. The importance, so you're associated with Save the Children. At the same time, you are the vice chairman, joint vice chairman of Shriram Schools. I want to know your experiences with children, especially in this period of lockdown.
Thank you, and I would like to say many congratulations to NDTV to take up this program, this very, very important issue. Children all over, the lives of children all over come to a standstill thanks to this pandemic. Very regular children in metros who are struggling with online courses, their teachers having to read, unlearn and do something different, or it's children who don't have any facilities at the best of times, children whose homes may be displaced because they belong to a migrant community, they don't have access to education, their parents have lost their livelihoods, and they are facing all kinds of issues, and they're also not able to do any kind of social distancing because maybe there is just not an option in the living conditions that they are in. Children all over are suffering, and it is up to us to do something about it. The main needs of any child is identity, which I say the children is doing a great job in getting Aadhaar card for many, many children. It is basic health and education. And of course, it is safety and security where they are. In terms of education, as many people before me have said, there has been a huge disruption. Regular schooling has come to an absolute halt. Schools were haven for children where they would at least get time on their own for a few hours. They would interact with their peers. It was a place of learning, and it was also a place which ensured that they got at least one square meal a day. And now all that is disrupted, and there is no knowing when it all starts again. In the meantime, as people are taking food, medicines, and masks and sanitizers, we should all think about what else we can take to these children, which could be education kits, which could be game activity, anything to keep education going. Because as we know, once it opens up, this is going to be a huge challenge for our country to get children back on track, back into their schools.
Do you know one thing I was meaning to ask you, Vasvi, before my colleague Anjali asked her question? See, you read books about the time of India post-independence, how India was taking care of the refugees who had come. They had huge problems in their lives. But then the Indian government decided that the best thing that is going to work is distraction. So there were these mobile vans where movie was shown. Now, it did not offer great solution, but it distracted the mind and thus brought in some comfort in their lives. Do you think that for all these homeless children, something similar could be tried?
Definitely. I think anything that we try, this is a good initiative because it will keep them engaged, will keep them learning, it will keep them from getting into opportunities of danger and of mischief. So I feel anything that we can try which can engage them and keep them distracted and learning is all towards health.
Right. Vasvi, what about post-COVID world? What will happen to these children? Do you think, as far as especially education, will they fall too far behind because of this lockdown?
I mean, it is a huge concern. It's going to be a big challenge for the government and for all the various NGOs who are involved in education. But this is India, and we have known to be survivors. We've known to be any kind of calamity, and we come together. I'm quite sure that we find a solution, though there will be challenges, like children may be in a different geographical area from where they started, so they might have to look for new schools, their parents may have lost their livelihood, so they may not really encourage them to go back to school and actually encourage them to take up a job.
Right.
There could be big gaps in their learning, for which the government will have to make a lot of effort to support them. But right now the whole education community is in a bit of a flux, because nobody knows what's happening. The board exams got disrupted. Nobody knows how the university admissions are going to happen, how the competitive exams are going to be held. So everything right now is just wait and watch and see. But I totally believe the power of Indians, and I know that we will come through and deal with whatever happens.
Thank you. Thank you, Vasvi. We hope...
Thank you very much, India.
We really do hope that gap is not that big that it cannot be filled and that the children cannot catch up later. Thank you so much. Aurabh,
I just like one last thing, that every up to each one of us to help fill that gap in whichever way we can. And absolutely, whatever little bit we can do, we must. Thank you.
और हमारे साथ अब स्वरूप रवल जुड़ गई हैं, जो कि लाइफ स्किल्स एजुकेटर हैं और एक्टर भी हैं. स्वरूप जी, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आपका हमारे साथ जुड़ने के लिए. हम बच्चों की बात कर रहे हैं और ख़ास तौर पे वो बच्चे जो सड़कों पर रहते हैं, स्ट्रीट चिल्ड्रन. अभी हमें हमारे गेस्ट ने बताया कि किस तरीके से अभी उन्हें शेल्टर होम्स में रखा गया है ताकि उन्हें एक सेफ प्लेस में रखा जा सके. लेकिन कौन सी ऐसी ज़रूरतें हैं जो आपको लगता है वो खाना और छत, इसके अलावा भी वो उनकी जरूरतें हैं?
सो वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग्स आई थिंक इज दैट वी नीड टू टेक केयर ऑफ द साइको सोशल हेल्थ ऑफ चिल्ड्रन. सो दिस हैज टू बी कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री. इट्स नॉट अबाउट रिप्लेसिंग लाइक फूड एंड हेल्थ एंड न्यूट्रिशन एंड यू नो छत कपड़ा बेसिकली इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. बट वी नीड टू एक्ट वेरी अर्ली. We need to act now. We cannot afford to wait for COVID to get over. और जब ये lockdown खत्म हो जाएगा तब जाके कुछ करेंगे. अब ही करना चाहिए. Because you know when we act, early action is very critical. We need to act fast and we need to of course do it for long time. So after COVID-19 is on, we'll have to continue doing it. But you know what? If we act now, we can stop simple symptoms from becoming full-blown mental health problems.
Absolutely.
Mental health is one issue which I am very concerned about, and we really need to talk about it. Because, you know, I find that giving food is my main thing. But people don't talk about the psychosocial health. And without that, we will be in a real danger zone. And it's not only India, it's world over.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I think I couldn't agree more with Swaroop Rawal. The mental health is also among those issues, just like children, which is not being spoken about enough in these
COVID
times.
And mental health of the children, that's
absolutely,
absolutely important.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
At a time when we are the depression capital of the world, do remember this. Prateek Kuhar is a singer, Jaipur ka ladka, ab humare saath jud gaya hai. Prateek Kuhar was a fantastic singer. He is the... Prateek, can you hear me? Hi, Sanket here.
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah. Prateek came to our studios also. He was really excited. He's very popular. Dr. Rao, you might not know him.
I do.
Of course, I do.
He's on Obama's list.
He made it to the Obama's favorite 35 songs list.
And asked to.
But he was really popular before that also. Prateek, मैं आपसे ये जानना चाहता हूँ, जब आपका इंटरव्यू किया था आपने मुझे बताया था दैट हार्ट ब्रेक इज perhaps one of your themes, very strong themes, when you think of writing a song and composing a song. How heartbroken do you get when you listen to a subject like this? Children.
Suffering. Yeah, I mean, it is a pretty it's a pretty bleak situation out there. But you know, I mean, it's what the circumstances have brought upon us, I guess, you know, at this point.
प्रतीक, मैं आपसे एक चीज तो जरूर पूछूंगा. पिछली बार आपने वो जिस गाने के लिए हमने इंटरव्यू किया था, कोल्ड मेस, वो गाना आपने बजाया नहीं क्योंकि गिटार नहीं था आपके पास यहाँ पर स्टूडियो में. मैं चाहता हूँ कि आज वो एक छोटी सी परफॉर्मेंस हो जाए.
I feel cold, I keep you close. And if I could hold you, I'd take you home. And when souls touch mine.
Yeah. Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you. Go on.
Great. It was great. Carry on.
Oh, sorry. I just got to... Okay, I'm going to continue.
I wish I could leave you my life, but my heart is a mess. days they begin with your name and I sing with your breath. I wish I could leave you my love, but my heart is a mess. My days they begin with your name and I sing with your breath.
Brilliant, Prateek. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Prateek Kuhar. Beautifully sung. And I hope this gives the children and also all those who care for those children some hope going forward. Thank you so much, Prateek, for joining us. Ambrish Bakaya is the Director of Corporate Affairs for Hewlett-Packard Enterprises India is also with us. Ambrish, again, same question. Do you think this is an area often ignored by policymakers, particularly, and I don't blame them, particularly at a time when we are struggling to deal with a monster we can't even see?
Hi, thanks. So Hewlett-Packard Enterprises, as a global technology company, we believe that these are very trying times and challenging times for families, communities, as well as for businesses. We do believe that it's important companies like us contribute and advance the way communities live and work. It's possible for technology companies like us to, you know, offer resources like supercomputing for vaccine research or Wi-Fi for medical clinics and hospitals, also working with organizations like the WHO as well as UNICEF. In India, we find it's a great opportunity for companies like us as well as for policymakers to focus on children, families, especially the ones which are sort of the biggest at risk. We've been working with Save the Children for the last 7 years, and they've been doing really stellar work in calamities and all.
I'm going to apologize, Mr. Bakai. I believe there's some problem in the audio. Blame it on the airwaves at this moment, but we'll come back to you. Zareen Gupta is now with us, chairperson of the Salaam Balak Trust. Ms. Gupta, you know, this is great work. Just a short while ago, we saw the photographer Vicky Roy talking about his achievement, how he got guidance. One question to you: using of different ways and means to educate these street children, make their lives a better place in these COVID times. What are your experiences and solutions for the way forward?
Yes, good evening. Thank you for having me on the show.
Thanks
to Save the Children, with whom we've been working. And having the children in the institutions, in the shelters, which is absolutely a need, with schools shut down, and they can't even go to the community. Street children are always free birds. They want to be out in the open and move around. So get them to stay inside shelter is very tough, because ours is an open night shelter, and to get them to stay within closed walls, doors, it is tough. So we have a very good team of workers, staff, without whom our work just wouldn't continue. So we've tried to have innovative methods of trying to do education. Not education just per se by picking up a book and teaching
Correct.
Them, but there are various ways, and we've got some volunteers, we've got our staff
Fantastic.
Who are doing online and are also coming to the shelters and staying 24 hours for 7 to 8 days at a time. So it can be a social worker, it can be a teacher, it's a psychologist, so we are dealing with it that way. As Shivakumar spoke earlier on your show, saying that they have these anxiety problems and problems of behavior. Yes, it True. Comes out. But at the same time, we've noticed that the bigger children, in absence of very talented person on
Correct.
Board, is able to take on charge of looking after the littler children
Absolutely.
And teach them, sitting there, doing things. So yes, education is very important. We have taken up our psychologists
Right.
to take art-based therapy to help them to not only educate and to do various other things
for education. And shelters at the moment
are a
boon for these three children, which the BMC has given us. We need many more.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
Zareen Gupta, thank you so much for sharing your experiences.
Thank you so much, ma'am. And हमारे साथ इस वक्त मंदना करीमी भी जुड़ गई हैं, अभिनेता हैं. बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आपका मंदना. आपसे ये जानना चाहेंगे कि हर एक इंसान, एक इंडिविजुअल, आप सेलिब्रिटी हैं, आपका इन्फ्लुएंस ज्यादा बड़ा है, लेकिन हर एक इंसान किस तरीके से कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट कर सकता है इन बच्चों के लिए?
Thank you so much for having me, first of all, and hope everyone is staying healthy and safe. I think the most important thing is what's happening with a lot of us is the mental health. And I think, yes, everyone is concerned about food and education, everything else which is going down. I think from my conversation with a lot of my friends and their children, I think it's when there is all this question which is unanswered, you know, kids are asking when I'm going back to school, what's happening, and, you know, after going back to school, how I'm going to kind of go back to my education, whatever, you know, they were studying. So I think that's one thing I'm really concerned, and I think as any individual, we should really work on it, and I think really the mental health.
Thank you so much, Mandana. Very important, mental health. Again, she's raising that.
Thank you, Vidisha, for being with us and for all the work you're doing. Thank you very, very much indeed. It's very good of you, and God bless you for the way you're working in this really difficult area at this time. Thank you for being with us, and many congratulations. It really has moved a lot of people. This has been a great success, and people can keep donating on our website for quite a while. But even what we've got tonight has been huge. Thank you very much.
Thank you all. Thank you.